equalizer. Ready for the quarterfinal round. Bigfoot is back and going after the world championship. Who does he meet in the quarterfinals? Memphis DK and Awesome Kong.
Scott Douglas, grab your honey and hold on tight. The bad boys are in Memphis tonight. Who's it going to be? Watch the light go green. Oh, can you believe this?
Look at Bigfoot. He blew Awesome Kong away in Memphis, Tennessee. It was not even the lane he qualified in. He switched lanes and he dealt with by a full length over Awesome Kong. Army's working his way over to Andy Brass, and we've got to hear what Brass has got to say about this new Bigfoot.
Andy, we talked about you having this field covered early. All the other drivers are trying to figure it out. Now you come out and really throw a trump card on them. You go to the other lane. Are you got so much confidence it doesn't make any difference where you run this truck?
Yeah, that's about right. You know, the truck's running real good tonight, and lane choice is not real particular to me right now at this moment. You know, both lanes are looking pretty good. We're landing about the end down on the ramp, so it's just kind of where I want to start out on the hill.
This matchup, King, Crunch, and Equalizer. Wow, that's the final four, and we're about to see them in action. The Bigfoot Ford, the Carolina Crusher Chevrolet, Andy Brass, St. Louis, Missouri, and Bigfoot, Gary Porter, Waitsboro, North Carolina, in the Crusher.
All you Bigfoot fans, I want you to notice something about your truck. Look at the yellow and the red stripes. That's the indication it is a Bigfoot racing truck. It's different than the other Bigfoot. This one's built specifically for racing. Let's see how good it is. It is awfully good, Scott.
Oh, my! Andy Brass lays down a shot and puts Crusher away impressively. And I'm going to tell you, Andy Brass is trying to make a statement. He's got some of these guys a little shaky. He's wanting to put it in their mind right now. Hey, I can't be beat. I can't be beat. That's what he's trying to do.
A four-second qualifying, a 375 first round, a 372 second round. What can I say? What's up next?
Well, we keep getting a little faster. The track's getting a little bit better. You know, I'm getting a little used to the truck, trying to get it adjusted to the track. I'm feeling pretty good right now. I think the truck's going to be running good, so we're really looking to take it tonight.
Now, Ben Scott.
All right, right now.
All right. It is time for the Monster Smash Final, Bigfoot and Equalizer in Memphis.
Army Armstrong's ready to set us up for a great round of racing in the Mid-South Coliseum.
All the people in Memphis, Tennessee got to see the new Bigfoot, and believe me, they were not disappointed. Cutting times down to 3.5 seconds. Andy, if any truck ever had the field covered, it was you until you went to the final round. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, that's right. The Ford General Tire Bigfoot was running real well tonight. We got all the way into the finals. I pushed it a little bit too hard, come down, landed on all fours, and just bit real well, and then busted transmission.
So the everything else is okay. The new chassis works.
Yes, it does. It's been working real well, you know. With monitoring our shock travel tonight, you know, maybe make a little bit of an adjustment for next week, you know, just the pressure and the shocks and stuff like that. But we'll be back.
Believe me, we'll be watching. A lot of people glad to have you back on tour, and I'm one of them.
Yeah, so am I.
That's quick. Not running it hard, but running it effectively. Dave Wysorek and the Nightlife Chevrolet will square off with Bigfoot. Not an elimination race. Once again, this is to set a qualifying time. Bigfoot 8, Andy Brass from St. Louis, Missouri, running against the Chevrolet out of Nebraska, seeing who can set a better time, and if Bigfoot can get under Equalizer. That's the question here.
You got to remember, 392, what they do, they go over a four-foot high hill right where they're setting now, right after they're starting on. Then over 12 cars got in under 4 seconds. Look at this, 6 foot comes out like a rocket.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot at 3.85, 700s faster than the time posted by Equalizer. Let's take a look at how things will shake down in the first round. These are the pairings. Bigfoot Fest, a rematch of last year's number one and two trucks. Carolina Crusher squares off with the Equalizer. It's not the Monster Smash Final, but this is one of the matchups they hope to see in Memphis, Tennessee. Bigfoot and
grave digger. God, these have to be the two most popular trucks in the world. Who's going to win in Memphis? Bigfoot. Whoa, look at the grave digger.
Wow, he almost took a piece out of the Bigfoot at the end of the run. But Andy Brass gets the victory. Dennis Anderson going all out with the Gravedigger, but a little bit too much Bigfoot at this point. Look at the end of the run. It looks like Anderson was headed right for him. But he gets it stopped before there's a collision between these two at the end of the track in Memphis, Tennessee, but not much room there at all. Andy Brass is out. Army's going to talk to him.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, when you're on top, there's only one place to go, buddy, and everybody's trying to knock you down this thing any way they can. Anderson gave you a handful right there.
That's right. Dennis did give a good run, but Ford Bigfoot, you know, we've been after the Chevy Digger for a long time and finally come around to where we got him.
Well, the vehicle seemed to go decently well for you, but Anderson had his hands full. He was all over the place. Are you aware of him being in trouble on a run like that, or are you too busy just driving your truck?
Well, I kind of caught Dennis in the side mirror there once, and I seen him coming over. I knew he was going to hit the hill hard. Dennis's truck, he's known to be squirrely, so figuring he'd hit the hill hard, he's going to be out of control a little bit. We just tried to run a straight race. I seen him, and also I tried to hang off to my left side a little bit to keep him hitting me.
Now Army's going to talk, known as the original monster truck, Bob Chandler's Bigfoot operation from St. Louis, Missouri. Been in movies, TV shows, won races, crushed cars, but the one thing he doesn't have that he wants worse than anything in the world is the TNT World Championship. Bigfoot's in pursuit of us. Against Buffalo Trevor, he's an easy winner in Memphis today.
He's got his first shot, the gold for the national championship in 1990. He is going to the final. The question is, who's going to be there next to him?
Well, kind of popping sound that time, though, on that run. Army's working his way over to talk to Andy Brass as we watch a very impressive Bigfoot victory. Let's go to that interview right now.
Andy, when the truck comes right across the finish line, it's making a popping sound. What is that?
Well, a lot of it is we're hitting up against our rev limiter, you know, which when it does, it starts cutting out the cylinders and then it backfires.
So it just actually stops the engine or hesitates it just for a second and lets it come back to life?
Yes, it does. That way it keeps us like if we put a button in, you know, say a 6,500 RPM button, which it won't let the motor get over 6,500. What it is more like a safety factor keeping our motor
together.
Against
the world champion.
Monster Smash, undoubtedly the two quickest monster trucks in the world. Bigfoot takes on Equalizer, trying to even the score. Equalizer comes out.
Watch for the light to go green, the front tires to move. He was sitting there. That young man cut a good light, in my opinion. Look at this. Again, green light, and he moves. There's green. Now he moves.
Wow. How close can you get? And the word from the TNT official is that Equalizer is disqualified for jumping the start. Watch it again.
God, they missed it.
Boy, I'm going to tell you, that is close.
And we've got the luxury of the replay. They didn't. They missed that rascal.
Army's got both drivers.
Andy wins a good win. Congratulations to you on this one. The General Tire Bigfoot really looked good tonight.
Yes, it did. The truck was running real well tonight. You know, like I say, the win was a good win. I think Dave got it off, jumped the light a little bit and was red-lighted, but I figured we might as well push it. They might not catch it, so we went for it anyway.
When you're as quick as you are, you know these guys are going to be doing that, right?
That's right. You know, everybody's coming up against us now. They're having to push their trucks hard. We've been running pretty hard with the truck. I don't think the truck's up to full capacity yet, but it's running well.
Okay, we're going to see you in just a minute. Right now, I need
to get ready for the action. Well, thanks, God, for the third week in a row. We still don't know who the number one monster truck in America is. The reason is Bigfoot and the Equalizer, the two trucks that everybody was afraid of, they've got a reason to be afraid of them because every time we go down to a final round, it's between these two trucks. But Andy Brass, tell us a little bit about this rivalry that's starting to build.
Well, the rivalry between me and Dave is been building, you know. The two of us have been meeting out the last couple weeks. First time he's got me, second time I got him. The truck's been working real well. We've been pushing the truck. We've been pushing the guys we've been running. We've been averaging a half to three quarters of a second faster than anybody else, and I think that's causing everybody to run hard. The first time I met Dave, like I say, I busted, broke a transmission in the truck, and the second time we just pushed Dave real hard. He jumped the line, and we got him. So now this third week, you're going to see it's going to be a close race. Both of us can get the light at the same time. It's going to be good close racing.
I think that's going to be the trick, is getting the light at the same time, because David Morris, your defending world champion, cut that light last week. It was eliminated by a foul start, but he was only a quarter of a second behind the awesome Bigfoot of Andy Brass. You guys are kind of the country boys this operation. They come in with a high-tech truck, have everybody worried, but you guys aren't backing down at all. You're still going after them any way you can.
Yeah, we've got to hang in there and be real tough and competitive all the way through this 1990 season. I think we've got the suspension that we've been looking for. Only we're lacking a little bit of horsepower now. If we can get the correct amount of horsepower with that, the truck will still be real good and controllable. I think it's going to be the answer.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned, because when this show's over today, one of these two drivers will establish himself as the truck to beat in 1990.
New Bigfoot with Andy Brass from St. Louis, Missouri. Buffalo Tremor will also be qualifying at this time, but nobody expects to see Tremor out-qualify Bigfoot right here.
Remember, under 4 seconds, the 382 is your quick time, held by the equalizer. Bigfoot, if nothing else, wants bragging rights. Quick qualifying time will give you lane choice for the whole evening.
Determine the brackets as Bigfoot comes across the card, isolated Army on a super run.
Boy, the truck really runs smooth, son.
Here's a Restore Automotive product point coming in. It's Bigfoot against Awesome Kong.
You know, it's really more than Bigfoot against Awesome Kong. It's over a 15-year rivalry between Bob Chandler, the owner of Bigfoot, and Jeff Dane, the owner of Awesome Kong. No love lost. Each guy literally wants to tear the other one's throat bragging rights out of Memphis. Who's it going to be? This will be super. Watch how smooth Bigfoot is. Kong has got to attack him on the starting line, Scott. If he's going to put him away, he's got to do it quick. He's got to get the first hop in.
What a great shot from the end zone. You can see how narrow Awesome Kong really is when you look at Bigfoot on one side and Kong on the other. Here we go.
Away,
but then almost blew himself away at first. Watch how close Brass comes to flipping and then barely getting it shut down before nailing the hay bale and the wall at the end of the Mid-South Coliseum. But Andy Brass is no worse for wear. Army's got it.
Andy, you take a bad bounce with a new chassis, you're in a world of trouble. I think that last run proved that.
Yeah, it did. You know, we've been kind of off to the right side and it sucked us over there. I'm going to start lining up maybe a little bit to the left on the cars. I've been doing it a little bit because this track's been pulling me to the right. It's just, I don't know if that could be, I'm just lining up wrong on the hill.
There's JoJo shaking and baking in front of the crowd at the Mid-South Coliseum. But right now they're shaking and baking over Bigfoot against USA 1. We talked with Andy Brass earlier about any fear that the seemingly invincible truck might break on him.
Well, my biggest fear right now is two things. One, the four-link suspension in the front, on the front axle. We've had a lot of trouble when we've landed, the front end coming back and hitting the bottom of the cab. And when it does that, we've been to the lower bar. Now, the lower bar, I carry enough spares with me that I can pretty well change one every round. But that poses a problem along with the transmission. If I clear the hill, hit the hill real hard, and land all four wheels with the power on, a lot of times we just snap in transmission. We get too much wheel speed. When we land, it connects and something has to break.
Scott, he was talking about that front end tucking under. That's exactly what happened to Scott Stevens earlier.
Ford versus Chevy, Bigfoot and USA 1.
Steve Wilkie is coming of age as a rivalry, not only
between Ford and Chevy, but between the two most successful owners of trucks. Bob Chandler's Bigfoot, Everett Jasmer's USA 1 is renewed here in 1990. 2 years ago, USA 1 beat Bigfoot for the title. Last year, USA 1 was the better truck. This year, Bigfoot seems to have the advantage. But Steve Wilkie's making up some ground. We've caught up with Wilkie in the pit.
What's the other thing right now?
It's the Bigfoot Ford. I'm going to tell you, Army Armstrong, there is a lot of unhappy talk in the pit from these drivers who are upset about the fact that Bigfoot took last year off from the TNT racing circuit to build this new truck. And now they're having trouble keeping up with it.
Scott, you notice the yellow and red stripes on the side of Bigfoot? That means it's a new Bigfoot. It's the racing Bigfoot, and it took a year to build, but what a year it was.
You know, the drivers are rightfully upset that Bigfoot could have raced last year and chose not to. Here's what some of them had to say about the new Bigfoot truck.
Well, it's sort of mixed feelings. Last year, he wouldn't come out and play with us, and this year, he's coming out and picking on us. And so he took a year off to, you know, sort of regroup and build a new truck, and that's all he's doing is coming out and picking on us this year.
Well, obviously, he has a definite advantage over any of us. He's had a lot of time to get his stuff together and come back out with a new truck. And I don't know, I guess I compare my truck. My truck's a couple years old, and it's really out of his league, you know. So I don't know, all I can do is the best I can to beat him.
I don't think the design of the truck is a problem, but they should have been out running with us that in 1989, but I don't know, what do you do about it? That's the politics.
Well, I don't like it right now because Bigfoot's dominating, you know, but I don't know, you know, if I could do the same thing, I'd probably do it too, but I don't think the suspension that he's running is fair to be running with Lee's spring trucks, and the reason I say that right now is because I can't afford his suspension that he's running.
Well, you can bet that very soon guys like Dennis Anderson and Gary Porter will have trucks to challenge Bigfoot and Equalizer. And I'm going to tell you, Equalizer is not giving anything back to Bigfoot. And as we get ready for the Monsters, fans, keep in mind, these two guys have met twice before. And although the score is one each, Bigfoot is still not crossed in front of Equalizer. It's time for the Monsters, fans.
Exactly like we are right now, with these two guys literally in a toss-up for the national points lead, and we're still waiting to find out who is going to be the national points leader. They're rerunning a run right now. If you had to do it any different, what would you do right now, Andy?
I don't think there'd be anything. You know, both of us run a good run. You know, I stayed in my lane, run consistent. Dave was running real well all night, so there ain't nothing really I would change.
Okay, we're going to bounce over to David here. You do anything different?
Yeah, I'd have made sure I kept my foot down on the floor when I landed in between the cars and the dirt hill. I think I got off of it too much.
Well, we're going to wait just a second. It looks like, boy, there's a strong possibility we actually may have a tie. Now, this has never happened before. If that's the case, they may have to go back to a qualifying time. I do not believe in this sport they're going to make them go and run these trucks over again. So, sit tight. I'm sure we'll have some replays coming up. We're going to get with the officials. As soon as we do get the official word, we'll get back to you. Okay, Army, let's go ahead and look at one right now. I think you can see on your monitor down there that Bigfoot and Equalizer are actually, you know, coming together, and we're going to get access to the TNT timing camera, and next take a look at that tape and see what the TNT officials are looking at. Because that's the determining factor right now, is if the TNT camera shows either truck even a hair ahead, and boy, you just can't pick it.
Okay, now both drivers are looking at this. There's Brassies in the left-hand corner. Neither one of these drivers wants to give the win to the other one. There's a strong possibility, Scott, they may go back and do it again. There's Morris. He can't call it, and he's not going to give it to Brass. Brass, he can't call it. He's not going to give it to Morris. I can't believe what's going to happen. The word I'm getting is they might be going back to the line, Scott.
we can listen in. The show must go on, that's right. What are we gonna do, guys? We're gonna run over, ladies and gentlemen. You hear tracking after Butch Krieger, letting the folks in Memphis know that they are going to race again. Unheard of in this sport.
Now, Scott, this decision was made by the drivers. The drivers got together. You talk about pride. He's no boy, no Southern style pride here.
That machine doesn't lie.
Neither one will admit that he's going to give a win to the other one. Scott, never before. We're going to see some history right now.
You know, the drivers in the discussion, from what I was getting out of it, Army, was that anytime somebody brought up a suggestion of dead heat splitting points, neither camp was willing to accept that.
No, neither. Right now, Bigfoot's outside. They remember Andy Brass earlier in the interview said he was worried about the front suspension. Well, he bent one of those rods. Bob Cantor himself, Mr. Bigfoot, he's here. This is how important this win is. One of these trucks will be the monster truck to beat in 1990. We're going to find out who it'll be in just a minute.
Trying to prove who's the bad dog right now. You look at it one more time, and when we come back, we'll break this tie. We have never done this before, Army Armstrong. We're rerunning the championship because the videotape determined it was a pure dead heat the first time.
Like I say, ladies and gentlemen that are sitting and watching this telecast, you are seeing history in monster truck racing right now. Neither one's going to give anything to the other one. I'm going to kick back on the end of the track, find me a safe place to watch this. This will literally be a war.
Bigfoot and Equalizer, and again, I want to repeat, Bigfoot has still not beaten Equalizer across the finish line. This will be the fourth time they've matched up, and as dominant as everybody's been talking about Bigfoot, he still has not beaten Equalizer across the line. The only win he's got was the DQ when they claimed that Equalizer jumped the start light last week, and Army, you and I don't believe that was the right call anyway.
They missed the call. Like I say, though, we had the advantage of looking at another camera. The track crew did not. Is on their feet. It's going to be history in Memphis. Take it, Scott.
Ready to go. Bigfoot on the right of your screen. Equalizer on the left. Watch the red light in the middle. When it goes green, it's showtime. The Monster Smash. Take two.
Chevrolet going against Ford. Look for the green light.
I don't know. Very close again, Army. Bigfoot and Equalizer. Once again, gone neck and neck, start to finish. We'll watch the replay, and maybe we can listen to tracking on to Butch Krieger, because we're not getting an indication as to who actually won this race.
You know, the replay keeps showing. You talk about evenly matched, Scott. Look at this. And the trucks are not doing the same thing, but each works good in their own way.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's see.
Let's get these drivers a little bit round.
Butch is getting applause for both of them right now. Butch will be the first one to hear the result. Let's see if we can hear the result.
Your winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Bigfoot.
How about it, Scott? Bigfoot for the first time.
He's coming over to see you, Army, and this is a happy Andy Brass.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is an all-American story right here. The man with the dream is on my right, Bob Chandler. The man that took the dream to the winner's circle today, Andy Brass. And Andy, it just did not come easy in Memphis, did it?
No, it wasn't. You know, we happened to run a dead heat there with him and then turn around running again. We knew we just had to push it, maybe pull the light a little bit.
He's tough.
Yes, he is. Dave's been running good all night. We've been watching his times. We was pulling 379. I don't know. Maybe we were sleeping a little bit or something because we went down to a 382. We backed up a little bit.
Well, congratulations to you and Bob Chandler. What can I say? You had the dream. You made it come true. And you told me earlier, this is just a taste of what monster truck racing is coming through. It's going to get bigger and better as the years go along, right?
I'm sure it is. Yeah, there's a lot of other guys building trucks like this. And suspension is the answer. Dave Morris runs suspension. Now, his truck is lighter. That's one of the reasons he got the advantage here today. But it's going to get better and better. It's going to be neat racing.
One more time, we're going to get a look at Bigfoot and Equalizer in the final. And Bob Chandler really showing you where it's at, Army. And that is in that suspension. Lots of other guys are getting ready to come out with new trucks.
You know, he also says it's neat racing. And that is a fact. A lot of new trucks coming out. Like you say, Bigfoot, again, has pushed technology to the forefront.
Andy Brown.
Brass, the winner in Bigfoot in Memphis, Tennessee. This time a clear-cut victory, as you saw on the replay, about a quarter of wheel length over the equalizer. Still, that really has no impact on equalizers.
It's out of last year because in the near lane, that will be Nightlife, also a winner. This should prove to be one terrific race.
All right, here you see the man driving the awesome car, and it is truly one of the most powerful, risk-taking operations in monster truck racing. This is Dave Weitzerek, the Nightlife 2 driver, a little more conservative, but he always gets the job done. Now, Andy Brass drives the Bigfoot truck, the best-known name in all of monster truck racing. And earlier, in round number one, watch Bigfoot on the far side of your screen, and you'll see why you don't see him in round number two. Bigfoot lined up and ready to go. Now, the rules say that you have to stay in your lane. You can see that Bigfoot got a great, great start. Was coming around the corner. Now, keep an eye on the Bigfoot. Took a pretty wide swing against Nightlife 2. And then on this jump, whoa, got way out of his lane and then slammed that right front into the ground and flatted it. But the minute he went out of his lane, he was disqualified.
Oh, absolutely. And I think what happened is Andy Brass got a little bit behind and thought, uh-oh, I got to do something quick. And just didn't get a good approach at the final car jump.
Well, that'll be up against Bigfoot. Now, everybody that's ever seen a monster truck show knows that Bigfoot is definitely the power to beat. And every year they do developmental work on it. Earlier, Steve took a look at the changes for this year.
If you're looking for new technology in monster trucks, all you have to do is stop by the Bigfoot pits here at the Astrodome or anywhere else, because Bob Chandler and his guys are always on top of it. Let me show you a brand new rear suspension. Gone is the typical coil-wrapped gas shocks, about 25 of them on the rear that sit straight up and down. This is cantilevered suspension, some technology borrowed from Baja Racing and Stadium Off-Road Racing. Look at these giant reservoirs. These are nitrogen over oil shock absorbers. Now, without springs, what do you do about the rebound? Well, you employ this tremendous torsion bar. Now, what has all this done for the handling of the truck? Well, it used to have 11 inches of up and down rear travel. It now has 24. It's got to be better.
So they've more than doubled the rear suspension travel. And the driver of the Bigfoot, Andy Brass, as he is on the line, ready to face Steve Kane in the Awesome Con.
Anytime Steve Kane races Bigfoot, he gives it absolutely everything he's got and maybe 10% more. And I can tell you, Andy Brass knows that. I don't think it's a personal thing. Bigfoot has a big reputation. The more you can beat it, the more your reputation grows.
Interesting matchup here in round number two. Two of the top powers in the sport of monster truck racing. And Bigfoot lays the power over 1,000 horsepower and gets a head start over Awesome Kong. But Awesome Kong comes back with some speed. They come to the turn. Bigfoot nearly gets upside down and stops on the jump. And Awesome Kong now is heading home and going to pick up the win.
I think Andy Brass knew he had cut that too tight and might be disqualified. So he backed it up and flies it to the line in legal fashion.
But the loser, apparently. Well, Bigfoot did cut that corner early, but then backed up and tried to get a good run at it. Here we can take a real good look and see exactly what happened. Bigfoot on the left starts to make the turn early on. Awesome Kong is coming a little bit wide. So while Bigfoot's turning early, take a look at the left front of Awesome Kong as it takes out that pylon. As a result of that, both are disqualified. Now Pat is with Andy Brass.
Oh, Andy, you're out of it at the Astrodome tonight, but you still think you might have won that race.
Yeah, it was, you know. It was a controversial race. They said both of us were disqualified, but down at the end down there, I seen I was going to hit the cone, so I had to back up, try to make a legal run. It's just something that we've been taught that, you know, there's always a chance the other guy making a DQ too, so you got to back up and just make a legal one.
Well, the fans sure love you here in the Astrodome, and I know that's a tough break for you and a tough one for the crowd.
Yes, it is a tough break, you know. Like I said, I'd like to try to take it all tonight, you know, and I'd like the fans to see me do it with the new truck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, Pat, maybe the jury isn't quite in yet on that. There's still some discussion going on among the officials. The other half of the semifinals will be Bigfoot versus Clydesdale. Bigfoot was disqualified, you say. After another look, and I think you agree with the decision, Awesome Kong, we know, hit that center cone. That was a clear-cut decision. You'll see it in just a second. If you watch on the left, Bigfoot said, oops, I could foul here, stopped, backed up, and legally completed the course. That's the ruling. Bigfoot is back into the semi. Got it?
We're back at the Houston Astrodome. You're looking at Bigfoot. We're ready for the semifinals in the monster trucks. And facing Bigfoot, driven by Andy Brass, will be the Clydesdale. Sitting there with Bennett Clark on board in the near lane. Bigfoot and Clydesdale. This should be a whale of a matchup.
And an even third call. An experienced engine for his driving would have to go to Bennett Clark. But look at Andy Brass go in the butt. And he made his turn a little bit later than on the run that almost disqualified him. And, oh, Bigfoot 7 has to correct. The new suspension might have been helpful there. It is Bigfoot over a charging Clydesdale.
Clydesdale tried to play catch-up to Bigfoot. Almost got it done, but the finish line was just a little too far away. Here they are, dead even at the far end. But Bigfoot makes a spectacular turn. Not bad for Bennett Clark either. He was really using that four-wheel steer.
And you know, it's like no problem. At the same point, Bigfoot just veered off course for no reason. The wheels, I don't know what the problem is, but he corrected. Andy Brass did, got lined up just in time to take those crash cars with the proper line. And of course, Bob Chandler, the owner of Bigfoot, always gives his drivers maybe a little more power than anybody else.
Well, and that new suspension, I'm sure, helped when he found that he was out of line to get a better correction. And look how neatly Bigfoot lands. Now let's go down. Pat Patterson is waiting for Andy Brass to climb out the window of the Bigfoot. Pat?
Out of this show altogether, and now you're back into it and headed to the finals. What a night for you and Bigfoot.
This is. You know, it wasn't the way we really would like to do it. You know, the last run was a little controversy. We got disqualified, but we come back and made a legal run after we backed up. So TNT's been really preaching it to us that if you do get disqualified, back up and make a legal run, because you never know if the other guy is going to make a legal run or re-DQ too.
Looked like when you made the turn down there, you almost lost a little bit of power before you made the second jump on the cars. Did you have any problems at all?
Well, I'm having a little problem right now negotiating the corner. I got down there the first time, cut a little short, and I cut a little wide. So I'm hoping I can be right on this next round.
They're loving Bigfoot in the Astrodome tonight.
Well, thank you.
Well, you know, Paul, you may have noticed not only to drive Bigfoot, do you have to be brave and clever. You have to be a contortionist to get in and out of this thing.
Oh, look at
boy,
that.
I'll tell you. Pulled up like a suitcase.
You know, and that was a nice comment to it. Now, who's going to join Mike Stowe's party? The winner of the monster trucks. And who will that be? We're about to find out.
Not only has no one left the Astrodome, the personnel and the snack bars and the souvenir stands have also found a seat for the monster truck final. Anytime Bigfoot is involved, Paul, well, it gets everybody's attention. The truck is just such a legend. It's the foundation of this sport. And look at Andy Brasco. He has got Bennett Clark and Clydesdale off the line. And I have to believe the new suspension on that truck is making it possible for Andy to do things like he just did. Make a smooth, attractive turn.
Oh, but what a turn for Bennett Clark. And he's trying to catch the Bigfoot. But not on the last jump. It didn't work for him. Bennett Clark comes in second, the winner, Andy Brass in the Bigfoot.
This may be our most interesting replay in monster truck competition. There you can see how ably Bennett Clark uses the four-wheel steering capability of that Clydesdale truck. Now watch Bigfoot over the far side, up the jump. He never even touches the car. Incredible.
I'll tell you what, though, Bennett Clark made that corner like he was driving a Ferrari. Still, that superior suspension of the Bigfoot made the difference here in the Astrodome. Let's go down to Pat Patterson.
Andy, what a great show you two put on in this final at the Astrodome.
Yes, it was. I think it was a good show tonight. You know, like I say, I don't think it come down like a lot of us wanted, but to come down.
Tell me about that last pass. You were wide open from the get-go and came all the way back through the same way.
That's right. You know, I've been dogging a little bit on the first couple passes, and I thought, well, I got down here to the finals, and I made a good corner. Just going to make a nice, slow corner, get straightened up, and just hammer on it.
I know you love to win, especially at a place like the Astrodome.
Yes, it does. It feels good, you know, here with all the Houston fans. I know they're all Ford fans, and they're all behind us.
Great night for you.
Thank you.
A masterful drive of a perfectly crafted vehicle. As Bigfoot now touches the cars because they parked it there, that's the winner's circle. Bob Chandler, the owner, builder of the truck, off to the side. And what a reprieve Bigfoot got tonight, almost disqualified in the second round. Let's go to Pat with second place.
Watch him come at you.
Now, John Moore gets off the starting line with him, but Brass just muscles it on the other end.
Boy, you can see why the other drivers don't like what's going on as Bigfoot is flat whipping them. Army's got Andy Brass.
Well, Andy, you're actually making it look awful easy out here this evening.
It looks like it might look like it's easy, but we're really having to push the truck tonight. You know, the elevation here has really got us messed up. I don't have the right build that I really need for the job, and we got it running with a new motor this week. It's a lot smaller than what we've been running, and we're really having to push it hard to keep up with these guys.
Say you don't have the right pill. Now explain that to me. What does that mean?
Well, the pill regulates the amount of alcohol going through your fuel injection system, and a lot of times you get up here in these higher altitudes, you got to start thinning it out, and right now I don't have what I call a big enough pill so I can lean it down.
How about the next round? You still look like you're carrying a high hand. You going to be the man to beat tonight?
Yeah, we're really hoping for it. You know, we need the points bad, so we're really going to be pushing it hard all night to make these other guys run hard.
Andy Brass will be bringing Bigfoot number 8 back out a little bit later. Those have been the semifinals. Scott Stevens doesn't want to have to run him, but he's going to have to here. And Andy Brass and Bigfoot hope to put Stevens away right now.
Scott Douglas is going to be the battle of the blues. Runs the Ford, runs the GMC. Close race with the Ford takes the win.
Auto Value King Crunch hung in there, but the winner is Andy Brass and the Bigfoot Ford as they go absolutely wild in Albuquerque.
Both trucks left the starting line side by side, but right here is where the chassis comes in.
And the winner is Andy Brass.
Andy Brass, it's final time in Albuquerque, and you're going to be sitting in one lane. Does it make any difference to you who's going to be sitting next to you in the other lane?
No, it really don't make any difference. I ain't going to pay any attention to who's there that's going to run my race, run like I've been running all night, and we're going to put them away.
One thing the fans in Albuquerque do know, it'll be a Chevrolet that's going to test Bigfoot, because the other semifinal has two Chevy. They're going crazy in Albuquerque here on Tough Tracks. Crazy for the Monster Smash Final. Here it comes.
Just that.
That's right, Army. The big blue Ford did, you know. It's like the old saying goes, have you driven a Ford lately?
Let me ask you a question. I saw somebody in the grandstand a few minutes ago. Bob Chandler's here. I haven't seen him around the truck. Did he buy a ticket just come out here and watch your race?
Now, Bob come out. He had some things he had to take care of. He come out and he wanted to make sure the truck was running right. We did a lot of stuff to the truck this weekend. We dropped down in motor size. A lot of the guys are having a hard time beating us and stuff, so we kind of went down in motor to give everybody a chance and stay even with everybody. And even though we need the points, we need them bad, you know. I've got to push the truck hard now to win, but we did it, and the Ford come through for us.
Bigfoot one more time gets the win in Albuquerque, coming right at you.
Todd, you know, a lot of credit goes to the truck, but Andy Brass is one fine monster truck driver, isn't he?
He sure is. Absolutely a great run for Brass, and he is now just 4 points behind the equalizer in the world championship chase as we look at the Restore Automotive Products point standings. The Auto Value King Crunch third, Carolina Crusher, Awesome Kong, then the Gravedigger still hanging in at number 6, USA One, Buffalo Trimmer, Nightlife and Outlaw rounding out
familiar
the top
name,
10.
Bigfoot with Andy Brass at the helm. And Andy, a lot of people are saying you completely got this field covered for 1990.
That's right. Ford Bigfoot's been running real well for us. This new chassis been working real well, and as long as I think I can keep a good level head on my shoulders, we'll be doing real good with the truck.
A lot of people say you have an unfair advantage with a new chassis, but laying all the cards on the table, you were running the smallest engine out here last week. The chassis is the edge.
That's right. You know, we have designed this new chassis. It's been working super far, and a lot of people don't like it. You know, it's real hard for them to compete with the truck. They're bouncing a lot while we're staying on the ground and moving. The truck, though, is it's a lot safer indoors. It's faster indoors. It's more controllable when we're running the indoor shows. So, and I like it myself. It's a lot smoother riding truck than the old trucks. It's easier on the driver. So it's a lot better truck. It's just a lot of the people don't like it because they can't compete with it. And right now, we had to drop down in motor size to give the guys a chance. And
I feel pretty confident with it. You know, we did real well last time we was here, and I think we're going to keep doing real well.
Well, last week, Andy Brass did definitely hold a hot hand as the monster trucks went west. The people behind me, they're having their opportunity during the pit party prior to the start of the ice race to come.
Number 10 spot. Equalizer has that slim lead over Bigfoot, and there's a lot of pressure on the rookie driver, Greg Holdbrook. Andy Brass has already gained points today because he was fast qualifying. We're going to look at the bye run in the first round for Andy Brass and the Bigfoot Ford.
Got something interesting here. You notice Bigfoot, even though they have a bye run, they still run the truck hard. Look at this, he's going right at the wall, shuts her down. Andy Brass and the Bigfoot boys, 100%ers every time they go to the line.
Chris Chapman's going to talk with Andy about that bye run.
Andy, for that to have been a bye run, it looked awful squirrely.
Yeah, it was. You know, it was a bye run, so we wanted to try something new. And it looked like it might have worked a little bit coming us out of the hole, but it was a little, like I say, a little squirrely there at the end.
What'd you try?
Just some stuff.
Nothing to share it with us?
No, I'm not.
There you have it. Bigfoot's keeping all the secrets in the Ford camp. When we come back, we'll be watching No Problem Battle Tough Enough in a
Ford Showdown. Bigfoot number 8 and Andy Brass from St. Louis. The No Problem Ford Bronco, John Moore out of Lafayette, Tennessee.
Yo, you're looking at exactly two opposite ends of the spectrum here. Big money sponsor in the blue truck. Bigfoot, Bob Tanner's operation, a class operation. The privateer out of the volunteer state of Tennessee. A husband, his wife, and their daughter. And they're going head-to-head with Bigfoot. They will not get in tonight. Oh, get close to that wall.
Hey, John Moore let it all hang out just a length short of Bigfoot. Still a nice run and a strong run by John Moore, no problem.
He pushed Bigfoot. Watch this. Bigfoot had to really take it to the limit. Look at the shutout problem these guys are having out. Bigfoot nose is over, barely shutting his wrestle down.
Here they come right at you, two big Fords, and the Bigfoot Ford is the one that gets the job done. Chris Chapman has found John Moore in the pit. And let's go to that conversation now.
With John Moore, the driver of the Ford Bronco, no problem. John, you did not lay down against Bigfoot. A very good time, 4.95.
Yeah, I really tried off this time. I really thought I could have got him this time. I don't know, a little slow there off the light. I thought I'd run him a good race. I really did. He's not unbeatable. Maybe next time I'll get him.
So John Moore at least thinks Bigfoot can be had, but so far he hasn't been able to do it. USA 1 now out against Nightlight.
Well, a lot of guys think they can beat Bigfoot. They just need about 4 months to build a new truck. It's nothing secret what he has, but they just don't have time to build it and take these points.
Getting ready to do battle with Nightlife. Now, earlier you heard Andy Brass say he's got a secret plan out here. It looks like that Bigfoot is rolling over the hill very easily, then hammering the throttle. We asked A.Y. Sork just a moment ago if he thinks that's true.
I think it might be. I think he's taking a little bit soft off the hill and taking off on the downside, which is really putting his time real fast. So that's kind of the strategy I've been using all night, and maybe it'll work out for the best. I hope it'll work out better for me.
Dave Wysorek in that brand new Nightlife. Maybe he's got Bigfoot's number. Nobody's had it in recent weeks. We'll find out right here. It's the semifinals. The winner goes to the Monsters Man.
Scott's going to be Ford Chevrolet. The people on their feet. We're getting the winner here. Goes to the finals. Roll on the start line. Gas is on the start line. Punch it at the stump. What's going to be the right combination? Everybody's watching Brass as he goes into the lane. Rolls up. Stages that big Ford. The Chevrolet's ready to go. We look for a green light in Albuquerque.
TNT starter Tracy Smart giving them both a look, making them wait a little bit at the line. Now he's second. Watch for the green. There they go. Bigfoot and Nightlife.
Both drivers get to the start line. Brass.
Bigfoot.
Oh, again. All right, Scott, they're scaring me to death on this end of the track.
Barely getting it stopped. Bob Chandler's revolutionary Bigfoot number 8 gets the victory, and he really picked him up and laid him down. And again, you can tell how radical that suspension is by the way he stops the suspension. His body really just seems to lay down on the suspension when he puts those brakes on.
You have a preference as far as which truck you want to run. Awesome Kong, and you put on some battles. But this King Crunch truck's been bad-mouthing you a whole lot. Do you have a preference?
Yeah, I'd like to run Kong, you know. I've been with Kong a lot, you know. I like to see Crunch get knocked out early, you know, get the points down on him. From what I can understand right now, we're leading in the points, so I'm trying to keep the other guys down as far as we can.
Boy, you got that one right. Not a whole bunch of love logs right there. Scott Stevens said before the break that his truck is broken and he's just going to the finals for points. A moment ago, Chris Chapman talked to a skeptical Andy Brass as he prepared to bring Bigfoot into Dingley Coliseum.
Andy Brass. I don't know if this is good news or bad news for you. Scott Stevens, driver of King Crunch, it looks like he's broken the suspension and the four links underneath. He's not going to be able to run as good as he normally would.
Well, I ain't got time to go in and look at his truck, but this could be one of Scott's tricks. You know, Scott's good for this kind of stuff, telling people he's broke. And then the other guy going in not running hard, because Scott and I have both had some pretty good times tonight, and that's all it's going to take is for me to slack off a little bit, thinking he's busted, but I'm going to go out and run as hard as I can.
Bash Final. We know the auto value King Crunch is not going to run a full shot. He's broken. He's just coming out there for points.
So, Army, why is he messing around? Why won't he get to the line?
Same reason you call timeout in a basketball game. You want Andy Brass to think about what he's going to do. He's trying to chill him out.
Like
Brass
that.
Has been around a long time. Let's listen to the conversation.
These two guys just don't like each other is the bottom line here. And that conversation with King Crunch is probably just, let's keep messing with Andy Brass.
Be cool.
Bigfoot's gonna hammer it though, you can be sure of that. The radio conversation you hear is from the King Crunch truck. Bigfoot's just gonna have one conversation. That's with the throttle, and it's gonna be full tilt. All right, now Andy stage.
Andy Brass, I don't think you're gonna rattle this guy. If he'd been born 150 years ago, he'd have been a gunfighter. He's that cool. Tom Collecting Stevens will not rattle the Bigfoot driver tonight, I don't believe.
And the Bigfoot 8 really would like to hammer the auto value King Crunch. Stevens has really been complaining about the truck, and Andy Brass and Bigfoot going to show him something right there. Oh, look out, Andy.
Hey, hello, Albuquerque.
He took nothing off and almost joined him in the front row. Wow-wee, but Andy Brass has done it, and he has taken over the season point lead in that Bigfoot 4.
Bigfoot goes to the point lead with a 3:19 equalized right behind him at an 0:08. Texas King Crunch sets number 3. Awesome Kong also from Texas number 4 in the Carolina Crunch in the top 5. Gravedigger stays.
It's sure to spell disaster. And look at this. The new Bigfoot 8 is banned from competition.
New innovation in the sport. Beautiful Texas Stadium in Irving, just outside of Dallas. Well, before one monster truck hits this course, the excitement has already gotten underway. That is back behind the scenes. Word is that TNT has banned Bigfoot's revolutionary Bigfoot 8, the brand new truck that has been dominating TNT competition so far in 1990. Army Armstrong is already on top of that story, and let's go to Army right now.
Well, thanks, Scott. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the story of monster truck racing. There has been a major rule change take place in this sport. It affects only one truck, the big blue truck of Bob Chandler, your current national points leader. Standing with me is Andy Brass, the gentleman that was driving Bigfoot number 8, the truck that was affected by the rules change. Andy, tell me exactly what it is all about.
Well, the new rule change is that the truck must contain either leaf springs, claw springs, or coilover shocks. Our truck doesn't. Our truck runs a nitrogen-charged truck on it. Shock on a cantilever suspension, which gives the truck a lot of travel. We're roughly running 20 to 24 inches of travel. The truck's been working real good, and it's been proven. I took over the points champion with the truck, and like I say, it works so well that the guys are having a hard time keeping up with us, so now they're banning us from competition until further notice.
Okay, let's get back to that one point. The guys are having a problem. The guys you're talking about are the other competitors are racing against you. Their point is this, Andy. They say, look, he came in second one year and didn't come back and race with us. We raced the whole year. These guys, Bigfoot, was touring with another company. They weren't even running with us. If we had had the year they had off, we could have built a good truck, too. What's your all stance on that?
Well, they could have took a year off, I feel. We run with other promoters and stuff last year. We didn't run the truck as much as what we wanted to with TNT. We did take the time off. We designed us a new truck. And like I say, it was a year off. It was a year of designing. The truck was put together. We tested it for 3 months. We brought it out this year, and we proved to them that we proved to the people that the truck will work. It does work. It's a fast truck. It's a safer truck. The truck flies better. It stops a lot easier. It's a lot easier on a driver. It's a lot better truck. The truck is more technically advanced, and because of that, we're being penalized and throwed out.
Can the old truck be competitive?
Well, I guess we're going to see that tonight, you know. It would be nothing better to please me to come out here with an old truck, still clean their clocks, and then go home.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's the side from Bigfoot. Now we're going to jump over to Chris Chapman. She's going to tell us the other side of this story.
Thanks, Army. I've just spoken with TNT officials, and they say that they're in the process of deciding what to do with Bigfoot 8. TNT's goal is to keep the sport as competitive as possible. And right now, the apparent key to solving this controversy is time. Time is what it's going to take for the other drivers to get their new truck ready for the circuit. At that time, TNT plans to let Bigfoot 8 return. This should all take place within a couple of weeks. Back to you, Scott and Army.
You can see Bigfoot has moved to the top of the heat on the Restore Automotive Products TNT Monster Point, passing the Equalizer. The Auto Value King Crunch sits third. Awesome Kong and Carolina Crunch. These guys have been running indoors all winter. Now they're really back outside and running a much longer course. Still, they're getting there in a hurry.
They're getting there awfully quick. And you got to remember one thing. There's only one escape route in this building. That's the one door. You're not going to fit two monster trucks through that same door at the same time. That could be spooky before the night's over.
We'll have one more qualifier once they get Dennis out of the way, and that will be Bigfoot. This is Bigfoot 4. And, of course, it is John Mayen, not Andy Brass. Now, my understanding right now is the points that Bigfoot 4 amasses will be combined with the Bigfoot 8 points because the points go to the truck, and you can make a change during the year. Just one change, however. We'll update that point situation as the story on the Bigfoot trucks continues to develop. When we come back,
Dallas for the second straight week on a historic course. And we'll talk more about three-lane racing in just a moment. But if you were with us last week, you know the big story was TNT's decision to ban Bigfoot 8 from competition. The truck that had dominated 1990 racing was not able to run here a week ago and for the foreseeable future. But TNT also, as we told you last week, was working on a way to get Bigfoot 8 back in competition. In just a moment, Chris Chapman will update us on the status of the Bigfoot question in TNT Monster Truck Racing. Now, the three-lane course last week.
What else we're going to be looking at today?
Thanks, Army. Here's an update on TNT's decision to ban Bigfoot 8, the innovative new truck that's been dominating the circuit in recent weeks. Based upon information from several other drivers about their new trucks who say that they're going to be ready to compete in several weeks, TNT will then let Bigfoot 8 return. Now the situation TNT is focusing on is rules. They want to ensure parity and competitiveness in the sport. So the first rule that's going to be changed after this week is limiting engines to 500 cubic inches. Then they're going to center on suspension. Are they going to let all the trucks come up to par with Bigfoot 8, or are they going to cut it off there, or will the sky be the limit? Only time will tell. Back to you, Scott and Army.
Good strong time for Kurt Fisher, under 6.5 seconds.
Here's the story we started the show off all about. Big John's going to be driving Bigfoot 4. You notice the missing of the yellow and the red stripe down the side of the truck that you've been watching the circuit on television with us. You knew the new truck, Bigfoot 8, was a race truck. This is Bigfoot 4. It is not designed to do this. And it does it awfully well.
He's side by side with old nemesis USA 1. Look out, Steve Wilkie. Oh, my. Steve Wilkie has gone into a generator that runs the laser light show at this TNT event and into the 45-second clock that Danny White and all the Cowboys, Troy Aikman and other quarterbacks look down there to find out the clock during a football game, and Steve Wilkie has gone through that 45-second clock.
He reminds me of my drill sergeant. He's still barking orders right now. He believes he's still in this. He is. Look at this. Wilkie is pumped. He's going to be back with that USA 1. That was just qualifying. Look at the bounce. This track is really weird. They're taking strange bounces and some heads-up driving by the Bigfoot driver, I might add, right there.
Yeah,
we
nice
could have
job.
Had a disaster.
Yeah, John Pyant got on the binders quick, but look at USA 1 smashing through a generator. Look at him scattering that in section as he then took out the scoreboard. It's a clock, 45-second clock.
Down there a bit. They're just overheating a little bit, but they'll be all right.
We've been keeping Chris busy back in the pits, and just a moment ago before that interview, she spent some time with Bigfoot's John Pyant talking about the problems that truck's been having.
John, two front steering cylinders bent. What's that mean?
When me and Steve were running, I had to get on the brakes real hard because we were kind of coming in together, and what I did is I got on the brakes too hard and wound the front springs up, and the traction bars hit the steering rams and bent both of them, and we broke a shock and bent the traction bars and just pretty much messed up the whole front end, but we got back together and the Ford Bigfoot will be back.
So you're getting ready to run again. Are you going to have any brakes?
Yeah, with the brakes, everything is all right. Just the steering is messed up and we got to replace. Now I don't have any rear steering, but straight line course, you don't need it.
He has to have brakes for the TNT officials. They brake test them as they come out onto the track. So he would not be allowed to race if he could not get it stopped coming in.
You're exactly right there, and that's a sign of youth. That guy's going to the starting line, going to learn another man's law. He's not just going to steer. Only a young guy will do that, Scott. Look at this.
He not only does it, he takes the win.
And once again, we see that the Barbarian gave him a run, but the victory goes to Bigfoot and John Pyant out of St. Louis, Missouri. So John gets himself a victory. We'll look at it again as we watch Bigfoot number four running while there's a dispute in the fact that Bigfoot eight having to sit out under TNT's ban. But there, Pyant got himself a win. Army's going to talk to Bigfoot's driver.
John, as soon as you came in after the win, you immediately started barking out orders. It sounds like you got all kinds of problems. What's going on?
Yeah, in the first round, we got on the brakes a little bit hard and wadded up the front springs. I turned the axle so far that the steering cylinders hit on the traction bars. I bent both of them. We was up there, we pulled the ones off the rear, put them on the front, put a solid bar in the rear, and just then when I hit third gear, it started slipping. I think transmission's going.
So there's a chance you might not be back in the next round?
Yeah, unfortunately, I think so.
We'll let you get outside. Hope we do see you back in the round. You're doing a good job.
Thank you.
This course and this competition is taking its toll on the superstars of Monster Truck Racing. Bigfoot is not the only one struggling to get back. Out in the pits, we understand that the outlaw crew is feverishly...
It was a very close race. Did you feel like you had it?
It was very close. I knew it was real close, and I didn't know, you know, who had won when I got to the end.
Well, maybe you'll come back as a fast loser. Good luck.
I hope so, and, you know, maybe I'll get another shot at them tonight.
Army, we're seeing it all in Texas Stadium. This is your basic reverse gear tonight for Bigfoot. The truck is running. Bob Chandler, Andy Brass, some of the guys are there to push him backward. The truck is running, and the truck is ready to go, but it can't back up. John Pyant says, I don't need to back up.
Everything's legal. It's all right. They can do that, but they came out and said, hey, we lost reverse. We got to back it up. TNT people said, okay, let's go. Chevrolet, closer to the screen. Watch where it comes out. Flexible's muscle. Bigfoot trying to come on him. Not going to do it. Nebraska Chevrolet goes into that next round.
Bigfoot, frankly, was lucky to even be able to make the race. The win goes to Dave Wysorek and Nightlife. Chris Chapman is in the pits with Steve Wilkie. She's checking on the condition of USA One. He's adapting to monster racing real quick. Well, there is the newfangled reverse gear for Bigfoot as they push him to the starting line. And John Pyant will try to put the big Ford into the Monster Smash final. To do it, though, he's going to have to beat two bad, bad Chevys.
Bob Chandler himself was out helping a truck. Now look at the lineup. Gary Porter out of North Carolina, the Carolina Crusher, Chevrolet. Then you got Bigfoot sitting in the middle with Pine doing the driving, the new rookie driver for Chandler's operation, and the privateer out of Nebraska, the Nightlife of Dave Wysorek. Anybody can win, but the winner does go to the final. Scott, you take the call.
Here we go, three at a time, showtime. Nightlife got a good start. They're even to the second set. It's Dave Wysorek and the Nightlife Chevrolet.
The privateer.
He does it. Dave Wysorek will move in to the Monster Smash Final against the Equalizer, the defending world champion, and the defending champion here in Texas Stadium, the Master of Disaster, and he won it on the second set.
Got all three of them look like a precision flying machine coming across those cars. Isn't that beautiful?
When we come back, the Monster Smash on a 42.33. Thunder Chicken at 43.06. Well, the final qualifier is going to be that Bigfoot Ford. All right, let's develop the story today. Bigfoot Ford is not being driven by its normal driver, John Pyant. Pyant was injured recently. The Bigfoot 8 driver, Andy Brass, is in Bigfoot Ford. And if we know one thing about Andy Brass, is he is not afraid of anything, anytime. He will let it all hang out on this course.
He'll let it hang out if the truck is 100% and you are not, repeat, you are not looking at a 100% Bigfoot. The truck stumbled right on the starting line. It sounds like a fueling problem. Brass overcame it, but it cost him some precious time. Look at this. Plenty of air. Now watch the suspension. See if they've got it figured out. We're looking for a little bit of a bounce. Oh, they're working good now. One thing, there it is, lifting the front wheel. It could be quick time. Scott, what does it look like?
Man, look at the air from Bigfoot again as Andy Brass puts him through at the only sub-40-second lap, 39.56. The fast qualifier, Andy Brass and Bigfoot, and look at him getting the air. You can tell that Chandler and Brass have this truck ready.
Well, they stumbled on the starting line. That cost them, I would say, 2 seconds. You got to remember that.
Look at him again. Look how high up he is.
Watch the
the driver when he lands. Look at the abuse they take.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot is your fast qualifier.
Does that surprise you?
Yeah, it does. You know, I was kind of watching everybody play the track, you know, and I told myself I was going to be out there. I wasn't going to be against anybody, so I was just going to kind of lay down a good, smooth run and feel the track out this run.
Before pulls a 39 out here, what do you think that Bigfoot 8 would do to this track?
Well, it's hard to say, you know. I know 8 would do a little bit better job than what 4 would, you know. And plus, probably John might do a little bit better than me, because right now, this is my first time in 4 trying to get back used to the truck. So maybe as night gets better, I'll get better with the truck, too.
Good luck to you. Thank you. Good luck to you.
Okay, thank you. Next run, Army, he'll be back. His fast losers are going to come back, and several of them. He'll probably be one of them.
Yeah, look for Porter, and he's a man of his word. Speaking of man of the word, watch the outlaw. He'll try to put a hole shot on Bigfoot. The only hope he's got is to go quick and go first. He doesn't. Bigfoot, now he goes down right there, 50 feet, and something electrical goes away in that truck. Andy Brass is sitting dead in the middle of the track. The outlaw is getting ready to go to the first turn. Now Bigfoot comes away.
The outlaw will hit the car. Very important for Bigfoot to go ahead and complete this run and get a time if he can get it started. And the reason is, these other trucks are breaking. They'll need somebody to come back. Right now, they're trying to get that truck refired so Andy can record a time.
Okay, what it is, they're running this truck on gasoline. The engine was built for alcohol. There is a jetting problem. In other words, the fuel in the air mixture is not right. But look at the outlaw. His motor goes away, and now here comes Bigfoot. Uh-huh. You talk about drama. These boys are really doing it in Louisville, Kentucky.
The outlaw gets a big, big feather in his cap, a win over Bigfoot, and Andy knows the way things are going tonight, that all he's got to do is complete a run, and he's very likely going to get a chance to come back.
Look at the left front wheel, Scott. Tippy calling. 13,000 pounds on 3 wheels.
Brass still hits it hard. Andy did not save the truck one bit, and I think he's going to get a chance to come back if he can keep rolling. But the winner is the outlaw like
one. Who we got coming up now, Scott?
We'll be taking a look at our next matchup between the Auto Value King Crunch Special and the Bigfoot 4.
Watch the 4. See if it stutters in the first 50 feet. Scott Stevens on the inside has laid all his cards on the table. If he's going to get ahead, he's going to do it in the first 50 feet. Andy Brass doesn't want it to happen.
Andy Brass wants to beat Scott Stevens worse than anybody.
There it is. That's exactly. That might be enough for the Chevrolet to hold on. But Andy Brass is going to be coming back like a fast-moving freight. You can bet your last nickel on that. Here he comes.
During all the controversy between Bigfoot and TNT, Scott Stevens has been a spokesman against letting Bigfoot 8 run. And now Andy Brass wants to beat him in Bigfoot 4 so bad he can taste it.
Two cars weighing 13,000 pounds. Look like 2,000 pounds. Sprint vehicles going head-to-head. Louisville, Kentucky. Brass takes the win. Look at the effort. Beautiful. Not beautiful.
Andy Brass puts Bigfoot 4 into an impressive victory over Scott Stevens and the Auto Value King Crunch. And I'm going to tell you, Army, they've made a lot of modifications on that Bigfoot 4 truck, but Andy is driving it just like he drove Bigfoot 8, like he's not worried about taking any abuse, and like he can stop the truck on a dime.
John Pratt normally drives this truck. He's injured, like you say. This truck lands a whole lot harder. It's a stiffer truck than Bigfoot 8. Andy said once he got used to that, he'd be a bear. Hey, he's a bear.
Andy Brass will now hit that second set in Bigfoot 4 and impressively put away Scott Stevens and the Auto Value King Crunch. Army's with Andy, and I know that was a sweet win for Bigfoot.
Andy, we know there's no love lost between you and Stevens. He's been going around. As a matter of fact, he's even got a sign on the front of his truck in reference to a lawsuit that you'll have against the TNT people. That's his viewpoint. You told me in Dallas that you would love nothing better than to come back and beat him with an older truck, and that's exactly where you are right now.
Yeah, that's right. You know, everybody's protesting the new truck and everything. You know, well, we brought out the old one and proved we can do it right again with the old one. You know, we don't really need the new one, but the new one's a lot safer. It's a lot better truck, and it puts on a lot better show. You know, we come back out with the old Ford Bigfoot, you know, and beat him. That just tickles me pink.
Go back out the next round, no matter what. If I'm going to destroy it, it's going to be destroyed on the racetrack by somebody trying to beat me. I'm not going to give up. Nobody's going to get a bye run off me.
A real Ford Chevrolet war. The Bigfoot Ford, the Outlaw Ford. They're both still alive. The Carolina Crusher Chevy, the Equalizer Chevy. They're both still alive. We go to the semifinals. Now, Crusher got a bye run in the quarterfinals because Thunder Chicken couldn't make the call. So Crusher should be a fresher truck. And Bigfoot has had trouble at the starting line, Army, in every run tonight.
Look where Andy Brass moves. He moves to the outside. He's going to have to clean.
clean the engine out, keep wrapping the engine. They've got to get fuel to the engine. The fuel mixture is not right. It's stuttering about 50 feet off the start line. And there it goes again. Now the Chevrolet goes out. Gary Porter's going to go for everything he knows he's worth, because when Bigfoot does come alive, here he comes. He's going after the Chevrolet right now.
But he's almost a half lap down, Army. You can see Cuthbert already finished the jump. He gets a little sand on his back wheels. Bigfoot bounces at the end and pressure is firmly in control.
He's not a half lap anymore. Here comes Bigfoot working the inside. Andy Brad doing a great job. They're going to go to the jump side by side. Scott, Chevrolet, Ford, who's it going to be?
Bigfoot caught it. Unbelievable. And let's wait till they get the photo finished. But Army, I think Andy Brad won the race. Look at him in Louisville. They've gone nuts.
Man, I'm about to go nuts down here. That was the best monster truck race I've ever seen.
I don't know if Bigfoot won it. If he didn't, you got to give him the big heart of the night. He was beat right there, but he keeps coming and keeps coming, and he either pulled it out or barely lost.
Gary Porter went bear hunting with the switch. Let's see if it paid off.
At the end, Bigfoot gave it all he had. Let's get a look at the angle here. Man, I think Bigfoot got him. Army Armstrong working his way over to Andy Brass and Gary Porter, but I think Bigfoot won. We're going to find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, you had to see, I believe, the best monster truck race ever. You just saw it. Between the Carolina Crusher Chevrolet and the Bigfoot Ford, Andy Brass, it bobbled on you right on the starting line. Have any idea what happened?
No, I don't. You know, we've been having problems with that right on off the line. All night tonight, it's been bobbling on us. We fixed it one run, and then this run, it acted up again.
Well, by the crowd screaming, we just found out you're coming to the finals. You took the win. Gary, does that surprise you?
It was a very close race. I knew I was going to push the truck really hard, and they're running against Andy, and right there at the end, I thought he did get me.
He was right. You're going to see it right here, and there it is. By about the length of a wheel, Andy Brass and Bigfoot, with probably, I don't think there's any doubt, that no one in a monster truck race has ever come back from a bigger deficit, because they rarely run any course this long, and he was a good 5 seconds behind him at one point.
That finish line looked like synchronized monster truck flying to me. That was beautiful.
Louisville, Bigfoot and Equalizer in the final. Chris has caught up with Bigfoot founder Bob Chandler, who doesn't like the idea of Bigfoot 4 having to race these trucks. He's not a happy man about Bigfoot 8's banishment, but he's got to be happy that Bigfoot 4 is keeping him in the points race.
Bob, you've got to feel a little bit vindicated. You didn't want Bigfoot 4 out here running, and you're winning.
Well, Bigfoot 4 is a 7-year-old truck. We've done a lot of updating on it. In fact, we're running 2 nitrogen shocks on the back. We are running leaf springs, but it still is not what I call a stage 3 monster truck. It shouldn't be running out here this fast. It is doing a good job, and I thank the driver and everybody else. It is good, but it's still not the right truck for this job.
What's your secret to your success tonight?
Good people. I got good drivers. I got good shop people. We spend a lot of money maintaining our trucks and having preventive maintenance. Just trying hard.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Well, here we go. I'm going to tell you, the crowd is absolutely going bonkers here at Andy Vertrees' beautiful Louisville Motor Speedway for this final matchup. It's Bigfoot number 4 against Equalizer. Again, a slow start for Bigfoot. Equalizer is building a huge lead, but we've seen this before. And here comes Andy Brass, a full head of steam to the first jump. Now Bigfoot's got the inside. He got a little squirrely as he came off the first set. Equalizer trying to build up momentum on the outside. It's going to be another photo finish. Here they come to the wire. Oh my, another photo. It's too close to call. Equalizer and Bigfoot. What a race between the two greatest monster trucks in the world today. Or at least the two greatest monster truck camps, because Bob Chandler's saying, this is not my best truck, but I think he thinks this is his best driver, and Andy Brass is airing it out. Watch him come to the finish line. They almost collided. Look at that. Bigfoot almost landed on top of the Equalizer. Wow. Let's watch it from this angle and see if we can tell who the winner is. Again at the end, Bigfoot, if he'd have come toward the center another 6 inches, he would have absolutely landed on the Equalizer. But it appears that the Equalizer
barely wins it. The finish line was actually right at the end of the cars, and Equalizer still had the lead at that point. He adds 2 points to his lead over Bigfoot. That's all. Equalizer now 6 points in front of Bigfoot. The Auto Value King Crunch loses some ground trying to track down the top two. You see the rest of the top 10 as we take a deep breath after watching some of the greatest monster truck racing ever. And I'll tell you, a lot of it goes to Andy Brass, who absolutely put the Bigfoot truck through the paces and got everything out of it it had to give. But tonight, that was not enough to beat the rookie, to beat the kid, Greg Holbrook, who wins his second straight event in the Equalizer Chevrolet. And indeed, Gary Cook has found himself a driver that will make that truck again a serious contender to win the world championship. Pictures will say it all as they finish one more time. We'll see you next time on ESPN.
Scott Douglas with Army Armstrong. Chris Chapman will join us in a minute, and we're back at Louisville Motor Speedway in Louisville, Kentucky, where 1 week ago some of the wildest racing we've ever seen on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge took place. And the guy who was really putting on the show and who was the big story was a fella who frankly didn't want to drive the truck he had here. Andy Brass made Bigfoot 4 talk on this figure eight course.
Last week, Scott, it was a game of numbers. Bigfoot 4, remember, that's a 7-year-old truck. A lot of controversy started in Dallas 2 weeks ago. The truck that they were running was outlawed. Andy Brass made the statement, I would love nothing more than to come back and beat these guys with the old truck. And Scott, last night, he literally came that close to doing it.
In the run against Carolina Crusher in the semifinals, I don't think I've ever seen anybody in monster truck racing make up that big a deficit in one race.
He was well over a half track behind us. And after the run, during a driver interview, I remember looking at the camera saying, that was the best monster truck race I've ever seen. Then came the next race, which was the final. So that was last week. These guys have got a handle on the track. I'm looking literally for the people in Louisville to buy a ticket today to watch a war.
You know, I was talking to some of the drivers off camera before we went on, and they talked about being a little bit scared of this course. They say, hey, you can see the faces of the people in the crowd, but Andy Brass is not scared of this race course.
He's not afraid of the course at all, and that is something that the drivers are talking to me about. You got to remember, like you said, it's the longest course they run. They're turning left, they're turning right, and last week's winner told me in an interview later on, he said, Army, he said, when I was flying through the air, I thought that Bigfoot was going to literally land right on top of me. Now, it doesn't get any tighter than that.
It doesn't get any wilder.
Because 42.66 wasn't bad last week, but Great Digger didn't get after it, and Crunch is well under last week's fast time.
Look at the bottom of the Bigfoot truck. You notice black smoke coming out. That's an indication the motor is too fast. They got to keep wrapping the engine. Now, they don't have the stall problem they had last week. It looks like they figured that out. We've got a good race going between a Dodge and a Ford.
But Andy Brass will come off with a look out for more car magic. He left his lane, but he didn't phase Andy Brass a bit. It did not alter Bigfoot's course. Brass tucks it in and is having a good qualifying run. He was fast qualifier a week ago. Maybe again, because this one looks good.
Look at the chassis. It's working good. It's hard to believe these guys adjust the chassis just like any other racer would do on this particular track. And Brass is showing he's playing hardball today in the bluegrass.
Coming out next is last week's winner to qualify, the Equalizer Chevrolet. And you know, in a lot of our conversation about Bigfoot earlier, I think, Army, that we were a little remiss in not talking about the great runs this rookie made a week ago and winning in his first time ever turning left and right in a monster truck.
Well, Scott, you know, he also took the lead in the world championship point chase. This kid is the real Louisville.
We'll meet the outlaw in an all-Ford showdown. But here it is, the feud of the day in monster truck racing. Bigfoot having to run the Bigfoot Ford when they want to run the Bigfoot number 8. And Auto Value King Crunch, the one truck that really does a lot of talking against Bigfoot's new truck.
Once again, Bigfoot standard just a little bit. The Brass back in the throttle trying to reel Stevens in. Look at Stevens, he's yanking that right front wheel. Man, no love lost right here, Scott Douglas.
Andy Brass skies again and almost sweeps the entire run of cars. Here they go to the turn, side by side.
Look how hard the chassis. Both trucks lift to the front wheel. Stevens has the back of the throttle. He heads toward the crowd. Bigfoot working the inside.
It's going to be Bigfoot with the win if he can hold her straight. Andy Brass. Look out.
What's that?
Now the sheet metal is coming apart.
Hard landing. Hard. These guys are really getting slapped around in those trucks. Stevens is stunned right now. Scott Stevens is having problems watching from the camera angle. I believe it may have knocked him out just for a second. Watch the impact.
landing is like a 50 mile an hour head-on collision. He just took it on the chin right there.
Auto Value King Crunch kind of disintegrating. The winner, Bigfoot with Andy Brand. He's with Army.
Andy, anytime you and Scott get together, it's just a literal street fight out there, isn't it? Neither one of you going to give either one an inch.
Yeah, that's right. You know, it was close running this round, but the Ford acclaimed Bigfoot was running pretty good. You know, I know we got up a little high in the lane, but at the same time, I think Scott might have been a little bit low. But like I say, it's just kind of, we're friends outside off the track, but once we get on the track, it's dog eat dog out here.
I didn't notice the miss that time. It seemed like you drove the truck out of the hole as compared to just trying to leap it out. Are you trying to dial the horsepower into it and stay away from the miss in the engine?
Well, that's true. You know, we've been just easing into it a little bit. You know, we ended up putting a new BDS blower on it. It's been doing us a real good job, and I think right now we're just getting too much air to it. We don't have the pulleys to gear it down a little bit, so I just kind of got to feather in and slowly feed the fuel and air to it to make it run.
You're seeing the critical part of the race. Bigfoot came a little high, but it didn't look like that had any effect on this. For some reason, Scott Stevens lost it and almost hit the wall. Chris Chapman's going to talk to him. It's time for the semifinal round on tough tracks. Micro Machines, the new Chevy, the Bigfoot 4 Ford. Here they go.
Andy Brass figured out that starting line. He's dialing in a horsepower, so he doesn't have the miss he's had the earlier rounds. Definitely to his advantage. Look for Brass to throw the final, making it look easy as he goes to the short side of the course now.
Oh, Bigfoot across the cars for the first time. Andy Brass turns it back in once again, and he is looking good. The Bigfoot Ford is running strong. Best qualifier today, and looking very quick on this semifinal run.
Like we said, this truck actually started its life about a mile and a half away as the Louisville Ford truck went. Wouldn't it be ironic if it took the win here?
Driving because John Pyon is injured. Andy Brass is making Bigfoot 4 not necessarily run like Bigfoot 8, but he's driving it with the same aggressiveness, and I think he's taking a lot more of a beating than he's used to taking in the Bigfoot 8 truck.
Well, I'll guarantee you that. He's getting slashed around in the truck. Look at him whip back and forth. He'll tell you that, too.
But he's not backing off because of the different truck. He is running strong. Andy Brass was in that truck, and it pays off as he is now the new TNT World Championship points leader, and Brass is doing it in the Bigfoot 4 truck.
Equal on it. If you just get up on the cars first and then get on it, you can do a lot better, faster time.
The biggest rivalry in TNT Monster Truck Racing today. Scott Stevens, the Auto Value King Crunch, against anybody in a Bigfoot truck. This time it's John Pyon in Bigfoot number 4.
Well, Scott, the Battle of the Blues Brothers tonight.
Stevens ends up on the inside retaining wall at Richmond International Raceway. The win to Bigfoot and John Pyon. The question is, how damaged is our fast qualifier? Scott Stevens in the Auto Value King Crunch.
He's done sitting up in there, Scott.
Let's watch it again, Army, and I think we'll get a real good look here at what happened to Scott Stevens.
Basically, all that happened was the bounce. Watch the suspension
He just bounced. He was flying through there. There was not a thing he could do right here. He's at the mercy of gravity. It hooked him and pulled him. Meanwhile, Pyan did his job perfectly.
We'll get a look coming right at us this time as Bigfoot gets a good, nice, straight shot. And you can see off the first bounce, Crunch is in trouble. And the auto value special is going to have to go to the store for some parts because I guarantee he tore up a few on that hand. Wow, Scott Stevens in a lot of trouble. And luckily, he didn't go over the wall and make things a lot worse on that truck.
On a run like that, John, you know, what do you do? Did you have any idea he was in trouble?
No, I didn't. I was concentrating on keeping my truck in a straight line. I really didn't even know where he was at.
How big a problem is that tonight? You guys seem to be taking some awfully strange bounces out there.
Yeah, I think the walls being in so close was really scaring everybody, and they were concentrating very hard into staying in a straight line. And I don't know, just some of the cars are kind of a little funny, and you're getting a lot of bad bounces out there.
Let's talk about those walls. They're close. Are you guys overcompensating? Is that what keeps making you go to the middle? Because the left lane's going to the right lane's going to the left. The only difference is the walls are on the outside of this truck.
Yeah, I think I definitely favor another truck instead of the wall. I think everyone is kind of going towards the inside.
Thanks, Army and John Pyan. A matchup between Team Crunch. The superstars of Monster Truck Racing battle for the world championship on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. And these are the two at the top of the points list, and they're meeting early, Army Armstrong. A crucial battle between the point leader Bigfoot and the runner-up, the defending world champion Equalizer.
These drivers are at the top of the points, one and two. They're also the drivers with the least experience. John Pyan will be driving Bob Chandler's Bigfoot, second generation. He'll be going against Holbrook, driving Gary Cook, second generation driver. There's no such thing as an old monster truck driver. Only the youth is going to survive this point.
Good start for Bigfoot. A little trouble for Pyan, and give it to the Equalizer. He pulls it out at the end. Greg Holbrook with the victory. Let's look at it again. And Bigfoot got him out of the hole, Army, but got in trouble.
Bigfoot drilled him big time on the car line, but right there when the rear end settled, he cocked around on him, and look at Holbrook flying straight through on the far side. Holbrook was looking at the end of the track from the start. I believe Pyan was thinking about each jumping separately, and it just didn't work.
That told the story. You can see him coming right at you. Holbrook was straight as an arrow. He's with Army Armstrong.
Makes you realize how tough these guys really go at each other. By the way, who's coming out next, Scott?
Carolina Crusher, the big Chevrolet of Gary Porter from Wadesboro, North Carolina, meets the big bad Ford from St. Louis, John Pyan, and Bigfoot number four with that new acclaimed sponsorship lining up to the start line. Now, Ford and Chevy, always a big rivalry, but you got two near the head of the class, near the head of the Ford class, always out of Bob Chandler's Bigfoot stable, the Bigfoot number four truck, and near the head of the class of the Chevrolet bunch, the Carolina Crusher, runner-up for the world title a year ago.
Chandler has unique ability to pick young and up-and-coming drivers. Pyan driving the truck now was a two-time top amateur BMX bicycle rider. He's a professional, or he was a professional when he was 12 years old. Right now he's got his hands full of big bad Chevrolet. Can Pyan pull it back? No! Chevrolet goes to the next round. The only hope the Blue Ford has is that he was a quick loser, Scott.
And he may well have been a pretty good run, but Gary Porter, the veteran from Wadesboro, North Carolina, takes the victory in the Carolina Crusher on the left-hand side of your screen. Pretty stable run for him while Bigfoot almost got sideways off that first set. It cost him some time. Right now, Gary Porter is out of his truck. He's working his way over to talk with Army.
Gary, you go to the finals by winning one race at a time, and you just took a big bullet out of this one.
It was. I think that was a good start there. You know, he's one of the biggest competitors out here and, you know, one of the best. And knocking him off early, you know, really, you know, boosted me up some because I need a win.
Gary Porter, the Carolina Crusher, will get ready for the quarterfinals now. And Bigfoot may very well be back because he had a solid run. And three fast losers will come back into the next round. But Porter looks good tonight. And that Crusher Chevrolet rolling on. Here's the points coming into the...
And I hope to have it out here on the circuit in August.
What about the Bigfoot truck? Now, this is a truck that the penalty is going to run out real quick. Any points you're going to get, you better get it quick because they say when he comes back, he's going to come on full boogaloo. And you know what that means.
That's right. I'm sure he'll come back full force. And when I bring my new truck out, coming out to beat him.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's great.
The original monster truck ready to do battle on tough track. Bigfoot. This is Bigfoot number four. John Pyan of St. Louis, Missouri will battle Mopar Magic and Gary Wiggins from Williamson, North Carolina. We have often discussed the current Bigfoot controversy, the revolutionary Bigfoot 8. We'll be back in TNT Racing in a few short weeks. But right now, John Pyan, Bigfoot 4, is trying to get Bob Chandler's camp plenty of points in the meantime, and he'll get victorious.
notorious point here over Mopar. We're going to look at Replay Army and the Bigfoot truck. Again, this truck here, as we saw in Louisville, still has a lot in it, and this is a good running truck.
Yeah, Ford's a proven truck. It's a leaf spring type suspension. They know it's going to work. So, like you say, they're just adding on to the points total, waiting for the Bigfoot number 8 to come back with Andy Brass shoeing it.
I think the theory right now, Army, is let's just see if we can stay close to Equalizer, knowing that, you know, Holbrook's probably going to do a little better right now until the 8 truck is back on the circuit.
Hit the nail on the head. What they're going to try to do is stay close with number 4. When they come back with number 8, they're going to slam the door on this points chain.
No problem when they go to the quarterfinals. King Crunch will be going up against Bigfoot, the auto value special, taking on his arch rival. Chris Chapman was able to talk with Scott Stevens about the matchup and the guy he wants to beat worse than anybody else, John Pyatt and Bigfoot.
Scott, it looks like it's going to be you coming back as the fast loser, and you're going to be pitted right against Bigfoot. How do you feel about that matchup?
Well, I'm not going to say much. Every time I say good, it always ends up knocking us in the face. But we're running a second quicker right now than he did in that last round. He's going to have lane choice, though, from his qualifying. So, you know, Paint probably didn't run that round as hard as he knew because the truck that he was racing wasn't that good. But, you know, we ran a quick round before, so we know we can run right with him. And that's what we need to do, just not let it intimidate me like it has the last couple of weeks. You know, I can't oversteer like I have been tonight.
Steven sounds confident, but Chris discovers that Bigfoot 4 won't back down. What do you expect from a team from Missouri, the Show Me State? Here's Chris with John Pyatt.
John, we just spoke with Scott Stevens, who you're going to be running as, because he's coming back as the fast loser. He says that he's about a second faster and doesn't think he's going to have any problems with it.
Well, right off the bat, I was going to stick him in the bad lane of the two, so that's going to give me a little bit of advantage. And I think the Ford Bigfoot's running really well tonight. I don't think Scott will be able to keep up with us.
So is that's it? You're going to beat him?
It'd be hammered down, and if he's going to have to drive around me, he'd get past me.
That wants to knock off one of the newer models. That's what's coming up in our next matchup. The Auto Value King Crunch computerized state-of-the-art truck against Bigfoot 4, the old reliable standby, sponsored with that acclaimed sponsorship out of Bob Chandler's stable in St. Louis, Missouri. Big matchup, a lot of war words between these two. Now they settle something on the track. Steven said he had him covered. He told you earlier he would beat Bigfoot, and he beat him convincingly on this run in the quarterfinal round. And Army, over that second set, Scott Stevens just put Bigfoot away.
He just literally, the acceleration is what took the win for him, but Pyatt seemed to have some kind of problem. He was not gassing that good in the second half. Yeah, he broke something. He goes out underneath the hook.
You're absolutely right. Bigfoot is out of it. The Auto Value King Crunch is moving into the semifinal. Coming up next, we go back to Fishersville, Virginia.
Stars, the greatest in the sport today, hooking up on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. We talked about him bringing the big truck out of retirement, and he has run strong. King Kong did not qualify especially well. Now he has to race Bigfoot and John Pyatt. And Army Armstrong, King Kong, you know, that qualifying shot was his first out of the gate with all the drive shafts and everything put back together. Now he has to let it all hang out.
Yeah, but the story here is in the blue truck, John Pyatt has to get through a round. He's got to beat Kong. Kong's going to really go after him hard. The reason is, Foot's trying to close in on the national championship point lead. Not to be the case. King Kong is definitely alive and well in Bowling Green. Look at that.
He knocks off Bigfoot right here and right now. And you know, Jeff Dane, the owner of the King Kong truck, has been battling Bob Chandler's trucks for a long, long time. And I know that's got to be sweet for Jeff to be able to watch Steve Kane drive home that winner.
That run might haunt Bigfoot in the World Championship point chase before the year's over, Scott.
Well, Bigfoot's got a shot to come back, but I'll tell you, he's going to have to be the absolute fast loser. Only one fast loser is going to make it back, so Bigfoot may be on the trailer, or he may still have a shot to come back.
King Kong literally just manhandling. Look at this. Steve Kane is so comfortable with this truck. He drives it hard, completely clears everything, and he's got an engine that's not 100%. Something's coming out the right side of that block, Scott.
Steve Kane and King signing a bunch of autographs. John Pyatt, the pilot of the Bigfoot Ford, gets a second life. We'll see him in the quarterfinal round coming back to the fast loser.
Well, very candidly put by Scott Stevens. He says he didn't sell John Moore short. He just got beat.
Yeah, well, that's the name of the game. But you know, John Moore in his interview with me said he's going to live in that right lane. You can also die in that right lane if you don't stay on your toes in this sport.
You know, if we decided just to sell some tickets tonight, Army, I think we've got to pack the house just for this one race. Gravedigger against Bigfoot.
I know we could, because I'm backing about 20 feet away from where I normally stand. I know what's going to come down the pike. These guys are going to go after each other like two old street fighters, but John Pyan jumps out on Anderson.
Oh, Bigfoot. He hammered him. John Pyatt puts the Gravedigger on the trailer, and he does it with no doubt remaining.
No, he literally manhandled him from the word go.
That may be the best run I've seen John Pyatt lay down at Bigfoot, and Gravedigger just never got it going.
You know, Pyatt is he's not new to the national touring sport. Did you know for 2 years he was the top amateur BMX bicycle rider in America? Then he went to work for Bob Chandler driving Bigfoot. This kid has been around. He does have a resume.
Great run for John Pyatt. Army Armstrong's going to talk to him.
John, you and the Bigfoot crew are back into this thing through the break rule, the quick losing rule, but you can still win it. Is that still in your mind?
Yeah, hopefully we finally got the thing figured out. It seemed like it ran really well that last race, and hopefully poor Bigfoot will go all the way to the end.
What did you figure out?
We rejetted a little bit. It's getting cooler as the night goes on. I think that might have been stumping us. I don't know for sure, but I think we got it figured out.
Well, we're down to four, and you're one of them. We'll see you in the next round.
Okay, thank you, Army.
Well, Army, I'll tell you, John really looked fired up. Now, he'll race either Bigfoot or Equalizer, and what a crucial points battle that's going to be.
What he's doing is showing a tech official from TNT that the engine is okay. There's no major problem. They see the same liquids we do. They're not going to let him run until they're satisfied. They're satisfied. Let's go back to the starting line.
The top two in points for the season. We have documented how John Pyatt and Bigfoot 4 is just trying to stay close so that when Andy Brass brings Bigfoot 8 back on the circuit, he's got a shot to run Equalizer down for the championship. I'll tell you, Pyatt could do Brass no bigger favor than to upset Equalizer right here.
Right now, the Equalizer's got one job to do. He's got to drill Bigfoot on the starting line. Close at half track. Scott, what does it look like?
It's going to be Equalizer on the second half. Bigfoot closed fast, but not quite enough. Equalizer holds on for a very, very narrow victory as Greg Holbrook celebrates his 19th birthday and what could have been a real subdued celebration after the races. I'm talking about his birthday party. If he'd have gotten beat here by Bigfoot, they would not have been eating any birthday cake with smiles on their faces.
This right here could be the run. This could be the battle that wins the war for you. Because he put Pyan out of this thing twice tonight in this point chase.
Boy, I'll tell you. So John Pyan's Bigfoot really gave it an outstanding run, but not enough to track down the rookie sensation driving the world championship truck. You see an isolation of Greg Holbrook winning it in the Equalizer Chevrolet. He goes to the Monster Smash final. Army's caught up with both drivers. Let's go to him right now.
Greg, 19th birthday. I've asked everybody around here what you did on your 19th birthday. None of them had the opportunity to do what you're going to do. You going to make any changes or just going to keep going with it?
We're just going to keep going with it. We got lane choice again. I'm going to run the left lane again. It's been working for us good all night. Truck transmission's beginning to fade a little bit on us. I just hope it holds up one more time.
That might work for you because he has been running the left lane. You're going to push him over someplace he hasn't been. That could hurt him.
Yeah, I believe he qualified in the right lane, though, and he run pretty good there. So it's going to be a heck of a race.
We'll let you go. Right now, we're going to bring John over here. John, nothing to be ashamed of. You had the acclaimed Bigfoot truck was running awfully good. When you go against this kid, you just got to do that. Got to go.
Yeah, we had definitely held it to the floor. The last couple cars and the first set of cars, a little bit rough. It threw me around a little bit, and that's where he got a little bit of advantage. We gave him the best run we could. It was a good close race.
Now, you know he's doing what he has to do because you guys are going to be coming out with that new high-tech truck in a couple of months. He's got to get as many points as he can get now because you guys are going to be coming like a fast-closing locomotive here.
Yeah, that's my main objective is to stay as close to him as I can. I try to beat him that run. We came really close, but I want to make it a little bit easier on Andy if I can.
Kind of shadow boxing with him tonight, huh?
Yeah, I'm glad we got the truck to run. You know, Ford Bigfoot ran as well as we could do. I'm glad with it. Happy with it.
Everybody working now on their truck for the
There we have it from trackside, back to you. Thanks, Army. I know monster truck fans everywhere are looking forward to seeing David Morris back behind the wheel of a monster truck, but this time the no problem truck. You know, this is going to be the last sight for monster truck racing. These 2 weeks will be in Myrtle Beach. That Bigfoot 4 is part of the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. Then Bigfoot 8 will be allowed to return. Of course, you remember the Bigfoot 8 controversy, dominating the sport early in the year, then banned by TNT to allow other truck builders
to catch up with the technology involved in the Bigfoot 8 truck. Right now, Chris Chapman is standing by with the owner and builder of the Equalizer, Gary Cook, to find out what he thinks about the prospect of having to once again race Bigfoot 8.
Thanks, Scott. You're exactly right. Bigfoot 8 has been a point of contention all this year on the TNT circuit, but the big story now is, are these trucks going to be able to compete? And one of the trucks that would be able to compete is Equalizer, and the owner of that is none other than Gary Cook. Gary, do you believe that your team's going to be able to come in there and hang with Bigfoot 8?
I don't know. We're going to make some more changes before we go back to the New York circuit with the new Bigfoot 8. We're going to give it our best shot, but you know, Bob Chandler has built a super good truck, and it's got the finest engineering that can be done, and our trucks are not up to his, but we're going to give it our best shot because we have run with that truck consistently, maybe not winning as much, but we've proven we can run with it. But for a point deal, it's going to be nip and tuck all the way. We're going to give it everything we got.
Have you talked with your driver, Greg Holbrook, about the strategy for the upcoming tour?
Yes, we've talked about it some. We're just going to go for it. That's all I can say. We're going to go for it, you know. We'll give it everything it's got, and we'll put everything into it we can.
Up the opportunity to let everyone know that David Morris, your former driver, is going to be driving John Moore's No Problem.
Tickled indeed. He has upset the Equalizer and is into the quarterfinals. Now, David Morris, driving the No Problem truck, has to battle for Ford supremacy against John Pyatt and Bigfoot. Chris is with John Moore. Let's go over to Chris now.
Are you concerned about the truck?
No, I believe the truck will be all right. I don't think we've got anything to worry about the truck.
After being a driver, he's now just an owner, a crew chief. David Morris driving his truck, the No Problem Ford, against John Pine and Bigfoot. Army, they're off.
He's an owner, a crew chief, and the most interested spectator here because he's watching Moore do his thing. Not good enough. John Pine rules the roost in that round with Bigfoot. Oh, Morris in trouble. Jumped over the guardrail you talked about, Scott. That guardrail is really going to give some of these guys some kind of problem before the night's over. Replay's coming up. Give it a call for us.
Watch it here as, first of all, easy win for Bigfoot 4. He puts the No Problem truck away by a bunch. Both trucks and beer left, and watch David Morris and No Problem come over the guardrail. You saw it right there. Army Armstrong is caught up with Bigfoot 4 driver John Pyatt.
In qualifying, the motor had that awesome miss in it again. You got rid of the mist, you're starting to win.
Yeah, it seems like we guessed on jetting again. We played around with it a little bit this morning, and temperature changed a lot, and we think we got dialed in. The Ford Acclaim Bigfoot's really running good.
Real quick, something major for the World Championship could have happened, that being the fact that your nemesis, the Equalizer, is out of this thing now.
He still might have a chance to come back slow loser. You never know. I'd never count him out.
Thanks, Army. Let's go over to Chris Chapman, chief with David Morris.
Coming up here on Up Track.
Back on Up Tracks, the Major League in monster truck racing is the TNT Monster Truck Challenge, and we got a classic Ford Chevrolet showdown, the Bigfoot Ford against obviously an improved Clydesdale Chevrolet. Army Armstrong, you talked about the sea level factor earlier. It's made Clydesdale a better truck.
Yeah, but both drivers are aware of the situation. John Pine's about some horsepower too. This could be just a good old fashioned side by side race. The Ford of Pine muscles it out the other end. John Pine back in form with Bigfoot number four.
Bigfoot looking good as the foot puts one down heavily on the Clydesdale and puts away the Chevrolet of Bennett Clark out of Powder Springs, Georgia. Let's watch it again as Bigfoot 4 impressively dispatches Clydesdale.
They went over the first hump side by side, but boy, when they came off, Bigfoot was much cleaner, made a great run. Now, Pyatt, they had a problem with that truck. It was a miss. That miss is gone. They're back in the winner's circle. Hey, we could be watching a big one tonight here in Myrtle Beach, Scott.
Coming right at you, you see Clydesdale left the first set of cars at a bad angle, and Pyatt was straight as an arrow. Bigfoot 4 gets the win in Army. That's something to keep in mind as this night goes on, obviously. You've got to stay straight on this course. That bodes well for guys who can go consistently, and so far, Bigfoot 4 and John Pyatt have been straight in the semifinal round, where he's scheduled to meet Micro Machine in our second semifinal matchup. But first up, look at this. The two chief combatants for the World Championship. The defending champion, Equalizer, his main nemesis, Bigfoot.
Now, the Equalizer's back in his thing. Solely through
into a technicality. He was put out in the first round. If this kid has ever been under pressure, and I have never seen him react under pressure, it's going to be right now. If he's going to mess up, it'll be now in a right lane. I don't believe John Pine's going to mess up. Bigfoot gets the okay. This could be a super run. Pine doesn't move.
Choked down right at the start line. Bigfoot had apparently more of the carburation problem that have plagued and plagued that truck.
I noticed the Bigfoot driver did give a thumbs up to the starter. That was an indication that, yes, everything's gold. He was ready. The truck just did not react, and Holbrook just flat put it on kill. Look at that.
Boy, Greg laid it down, but again, it was the starting line that killed Bigfoot number four. Chris Chapman has got John Pine. Let's see what the problem was.
John, you had some problems on the line with Bigfoot. What happened?
The easiest way to put it is just driver error. I just made a big mistake, and we didn't go nowhere when the green light came on.
What's going to happen now with the Bigfoot team? Bigfoot 8 will return to the circuit. Can you make any predictions? It's been touch and go all year long between you all and Equalizer.
It seems like Andy's been running the truck a lot on the West Coast, and he's got a lot of bugs worked out of. He knows the truck a lot better than from when he left the circuit, and he's going to be coming back real strong. Everybody else better watch out.
There you get a look at it, ladies and gentlemen. In just 2 weeks on Tough Tracks, the return of Bigfoot 8 and Andy Brass, and the Big Four thinks he can still pull off the world championship.
You know, Scott, that's kind of interesting, the respect that John Pine has for Andy Brass. John Pine is an awfully good driver himself, driving the old number four truck. Not to be ashamed of, but right now we're going back to the start line with the
Monsters are in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina for more side-by-side competition. Last week it was Greg Holbrook and the Equalizer taking the victory. He'll try to do it again here today. But Army Armstrong, one of the big stories today in Myrtle Beach is going to be to keep our eyes on the Bigfoot 4 truck. This could be the last time we see Bigfoot 4 in TNT competition.
Yeah, the words come down to us that this will be the last time we're going to see 4 because they're going after the world championship, but they're going to use the 8 truck to do it. Now, those of you that follow the sport know the scenario. The 8 truck, they had to set it out for 2 months in order to allow the rest of the trucks to catch up with it. And I believe it could have happened. If you look at the truck right behind us, you'll notice some new shock absorbers. These shocks cost $1,500 a piece. They're manufactured in California. A lot of people are getting involved in the technical end of these monster trucks. So the drivers feel like, bring on Bigfoot 8. We're
Bigfoot
ready for
four.
It.
This is Bigfoot number four and John Pyatt. Army, this is going to be our last week of seeing Bigfoot number four. And I guess as a postscript, John Pyatt has done the job. He has kept Bigfoot in contention, and next week, Andy Brass comes back full tilt in Bigfoot number 8.
Well, John Pyatt had a lot of pressure on him, and the pressure was from staying close. Exactly what he did, this young man has proven beyond a doubt he's a good monster truck driver. I look for him to step up and become a Bob Chandler's later equipment, but right now, all eyes will turn to Andy Brass and Bigfoot 8 when this night's over. This is the swan song for number 4 in Myrtle Beach.
As of next week, that thing will be an antique, but right now, it gets a big victory in the points race for the Bigfoot camp of Bob Chandler. The win goes to Bigfoot number 4 and John Pyatt. Army Armstrong is going to go talk with the Ford driver.
John, word is, this is the last time we're going to have a chance to see Bigfoot 4. You're trying to take this thing out of here on a winning note.
Concerned, and I want everyone to know who John Pyatt is.
They're definitely learning your name in a hurry. Each time, you seem to be getting a little bit more confidence in the truck.
Yeah, before the series started, I took a month off with a neck injury, and I'm just now getting back in the swing of things. I had all that time off sitting and watching, and I'm ready to get back in the seat now.
You actually did that. You actually sat down and looked at videos of back studying the defensive team.
Yeah, every week, every show that is taped, that we get to go back in the shop and see that, even though Andy might have been running a race, I'm watching what everybody else is doing.
The study, the work that goes into driving the Bigfoot truck, according to John Pyatt.
You know, it's kind of interesting, Scott. Before he was a Bigfoot driver, he was a world champion top amateur BMX bicycle rider.
Kurt Fisher is a former world champion mud racer. He had a good run a week ago, but not today.
And
here's Chris Chapman.
Third gear, you don't have time to go ahead and shift it into neutral, rev your motor up, drop it back in gear when you're racing.
You know, it's kind of funny that that happened to him, because if you remember, last week, the same thing happened to John Pine, the Bigfoot on the start line. He said brain fade cost him a win last week. Let's see what he's going to do now.
The swan song of Bigfoot 4. Will it continue? Yes! Bigfoot puts Mopar away, and he'll go to the semifinals. And look at this.
Mike Wine and the Outlaw is running strong, having a great night. And what does he want? He wants to beat Bigfoot and claim supremacy in the Ford camp. He's going to meet him in the semifinals.
Bigfoot made a phone call home. Bob Chandler said it's the last time we run the truck. Whatever it takes, that's what you got to do to win.
He's looking good. There he is. John Pyant, the winner in Bigfoot number 4. Army Armstrong is going to talk to him now.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is kind of a historic evening. The reason it's historic is could be the last time they're ever going to run the Ford truck. You said a moment ago in your interview that you're going to go out in a blaze of glory. You go to the next round. Does everything feel okay?
Yeah, the Ford acclaimed Bigfoot is running great. There, we have Donnie Kessel, my crew guy, and I have been working on it, and there is no problems at all with the truck.
You guys are kind of young to be in monster truck racing. An accident like we had a moment ago, does that affect you at all?
No, not at all. I rolled this truck over about 3 or 4 months ago, and 15 minutes later, I was out racing again. We put 2 quarts of oil in and went out. It does not scare me at all.
Bigfoot, you'll see him in the left-hand lane. When he comes back in the semifinals, he is going to have to go up against the guy who wants to beat him worse than anybody else out there. Mike Wine and the Outlaw want to be the king of the Fords. Chris Chapman just talked with Mike Wine about taking on the king of the monster trucks.
I can't wait to get Foot. I am dying to be Foot. 2 years I've never beat him. He's embarrassed me. Never again.
Colebrook waving to the crowd. And I mean, the old truck of the Carolina Crusher holding up well for Gary Porter. And, you know, Army, I think Porter's going to hate turning that truck over.
Yeah, I think he will, too. We were talking about the old pair of shoes and how you feel comfortable in it. This guy has built a nest there. Speaking of building a nest, you notice the decal on the front window. That says, get well quick, Daryl Gwynn, one of our drag racing friends, injured in an accident. All the monster truck people want Daryl to know, we're pulling for you, buddy. Hang in there. Now we're going to see who's going to represent Ford in the final. Will it be the Outlaw or Bigfoot?
Mike Wine may gnaw the steering wheel in half getting ready for this one. He is on ready, dead set ready. The Outlaw wants a whole bunch of Bigfoot. John Pyant, relatively new to driving the Bigfoot truck, can he appreciate what this race means to the Outlaw and Mike Wine?
Yeah, I believe so. Everybody starts and works their way up the ladder. These guys are battling the same rung up the ladder. One has a big sponsor, that being Pyant. Meanwhile, Wine, he's working his way with Nick Rossi. Here we go. Rossi and the Outlaw. Mike Wine holding off the charge. He does it. He does it. You believe it, Scott.
The biggest win in the career of Mike Wine. Racing team has just been entered in the books.
This is going to be a great interview, and you just saw the last run of old number 4.
Bigfoot 4 is going to a museum somewhere, I guess, because you can stick a fork in that truck as far as the TNT Monster Truck Challenge is concerned. It's done, and the Outlaw did what he wanted to do, retiring one match earlier than he wanted to go out. Mike Wine getting the win in the Outlaw, and as we look at this replay, Army Armstrong is going to talk to a fired up Mike Wine.
Mike Wine, you're taking your truck back to the pit area. Your crew says it's 100% ready to go to the final.
100%, no problems at all. The only reason we keep taking it back, we're from a gasoline motor to an alcohol motor, and we still only got a 10-gallon fuel cell in it. I'm about out of fuel when I get down there, but he'll get it back. That's my boss. He'll fill it up. That's my crew chief, too. Everybody was afraid when I got in this lane right here, I'd be afraid of that wall last week. Well, I'm ready for this lane, I'm ready for this wall, and I'm ready for Equalizer now.
I'll tell you something you don't know, I can tell by this interview. You're not going to be in this lane, you're not going to be in the wall. He likes the lane, he likes the wall, he's going to push you on the other side.
That's fine with me. Less wall, more throttle on an open lane back here. That means I got a lot of runaway to slow down. I can finally open that motor up. I'm tired of running at half throttle.
For him again on a tour later in the year, but the big question tonight in New Jersey, look who's back in town.
Bigfoot number 8, Andy Brass, is back after being banned temporarily by TNT to allow the other trucks a chance to catch up with his technology. Earlier, Army caught up with Andy Brass. Here's what Andy had to say about trying to catch the Equalizer.
Bigfoot is back in town, and we're standing with the driver of Bigfoot, Andy Brass, a man that in this sport is under a whole lot of pressure. Andy, it's time to go to war.
Yeah, that's right. You know, we've been out of the running now for about 2.5 months, and we've lost a lot of points, and me having to come back and get the points back to get back into first place, there's a lot of pressure on me. I'm going to have to run the truck hard. I'm going to have to watch these guys, see how they're running, and really, you know, kind of push the truck hard. It's going to be a little hard on me, but I think we can do it.
You're going to be driving the Bigfoot number 8 truck. It's a lot different than any other monster truck on the circuit. Real quick, why is it different?
Well, we run a cantilever suspension on it. It gives us 18 inches of travel in the front, 24 in the back. You know, the truck has a lot of side-to-side roll, a lot of front to rear roll. You know, we do a lot of weight distribution on the truck. You know, it gets a lot of traction. It carries the front wheels, you know, and it's just like a sponge. Once it lands, it sticks.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's the setup from the Bigfoot operation.
Well,
right now,
King Crunch, certainly one of the ringleaders in the anti-Bigfoot camp, the guy who earlier on this year complained probably most loudly, Army, about Bigfoot 8 being allowed to run while he took last year off. Well, he's back now, and isn't it funny that he'll have to stare against him in this qualifying round right out of the chute?
Well, since all the problems started early in the year, like you explained, there's no love lost between these guys, but there is a lot of respect between Scott Stevens' camp and the Bob Chandler camp, with Andy Brass doing the driving. Like you say, it's kind of ironic. They go head-to-head, and Bigfoot immediately comes out and shows what it's all about. Oh, he's in trouble! Stevens makes a clean run. Bigfoot's in trouble. Bigfoot and Holbrook.
You know, you got to wonder what's going
right
on
now, yeah.
The two best monster trucks in the world, it makes you wonder what's happening, Army, because they both are disqualified, and it was a mess for both of them on the second set.
Pressure. That's what it's all about in Flemington.
Let's watch the run again, and you can see how badly Bigfoot misses this second set. That's not even close.
Okay. What he does, it's the same lane, and both trucks are having a problem out of the same lane. Watch the rear of the truck when he comes off the first set of cars. The rear steer on this truck is turning. I noticed it just a moment ago. He drives with the front, but the rear is still going where it wants to go. Let's see if the same action takes place now.
This is his second qualifying attempt. Bigfoot comes right back. Andy Brass looking for a legal shot.
There it is. Now, see, he had the back pedal keep everything straight. Good run.
Yeah, something right off that first set he's got to be careful about, obviously. And Bigfoot, with a three-second penalty, comes in at 9:42. That means the 6:42 he covered the course in is the quickest anybody has set down, but the three-second penalty is going to shuffle him way back in the field.
And Brass is right back to driving like he always has. He's just a street fighter-type driver, full boogaloo, lays down a six-second shot. It's going to cost him nine.
Watch right here. Look in the cab. You can see Andy really taking a beat, fighting that steering wheel. Andy standing by now with Chris Chapman.
Andy, it took two tries to qualify. What's going on with Bigfoot?
Well, I'm not really sure. You know, the first run, you know, the truck veered real hard to the right. We had that problem a little bit last week. You know, I watched Equalizer. He made the same thing happen to him. There's a hole in the cars. And I'm pretty sure the first run, we just hit that hole and it just sucked us right off the cars. You know, I watched Equalizer again. His run, the same thing happened to him again. So these newer suspension trucks, it seems like when we're hitting the holes in the cars, it just pulls us one way or the other.
What type of adjustments were you making?
Well, I'm doing a little bit of shock adjustment right now, trying to compensate for it pulling me left or right. You know, I'm going to adjust sway bar a little bit, maybe make some gearing changes.
Don't brag on any
now, second bad break for Dennis Anderson. And again, even though the others had 3-second penalties, he was competitive time-wise with Bigfoot and with Equalizer, even if you take those penalties off, although he wouldn't have been past qualifier. So real bad break for Dennis. Now the Bigfoot 8 back in side-by-side competition.
Andy Brass said the truck lands like a sponge and it sticks. That's exactly what's happened. He was in trouble at half track. Meanwhile, the Clydesdale's all over the track, but Andy Brass literally had the back pedal take the brake and hit the throttle again in order to take the win. That truck is not handling right yet, Scott.
Clydesdale has been disqualified and Bigfoot barely was legal. Let's watch the run.
Okay, watch between the jumps. Bigfoot, he's on the gas right now. He's throttled up, but at this point, he tags the brake. Now nails the throttle again. Clydesdale sees Bigfoot having trouble. He's going after his throat. It's not going to work.
Right you are, Army. Matter of fact, here comes Andy Brass your way now.
Andy, the chassis seemed to have a little bit of flex in it or twist in it and qualifying, and it still seems to be there, to be honest with you.
Yeah, that's right. The frame's flexing a lot. You know, I think a lot of it is it's just the cars. You know, the truck's moving to the cars. We're getting a big hole at the end, and the truck's kind of following the hole, and it's throwing off, you know, one side or the other, and it's causing us to have to really kind of react in it in between the cars, and right now it's slick, and, it, you know, whatever adjustment you're making, you're sliding out there.
And we'll be Marvin Smith in the wild here as we move into the quarterfinal round. Lots of pressure on Bigfoot. He knows he's in a bad lane, but knowing he has to make up 80 points on the Equalizer, every single run is critical.
Scott, the bad part of the lane we keep talking about is at the end of the first set of cars. He can beat the problem if he jumps the first set of cars. He tried it. Again, he's in trouble. There it is again. Back on the throttle. Smith, who won it? I couldn't tell.
I don't think Bigfoot got up on the cars. He's going to be disqualified after getting thrown to the right. And Marvin Smith will come up with an upset victory over Bigfoot 8. And I think it's going to go down as a disqualification, which means he's definitely out for the night.
Again, watch Brass. He's trying to clear the first set of cars. It doesn't settle right. The rear end comes around. He tags the brake. Nails the throttle. Not going to work. Smith is coming like a fast-moving freight.
Well, Marvin Smith actually lost twice, if you want to look at this as a loss in terms of getting across the finish line, but he's still going into the semifinals in the Wild Hare Chevrolet. And in the meantime, the much-heralded return of Bigfoot number 8 comes to a very premature ending. Marvin Smith is out, but Chris is over to talk with Andy Brass.
Andy, that hole got you twice.
Yeah, it did. You know, it's just something we've been trying to figure out. You know, I pulled this side, tried to pull a little bit this way, and just a little bit too much, I guess.
What about next time here on Tough Tracks? Is there going to be any type of major change with Bigfoot 8, or are you just going to try to ride it out?
Yeah, we're just going to try to ride it out right now. You know, we're out here on a big tour, and it's going to be a little while. It's a little hard to work on the truck. You know, we're out here hitting show after show after show, so it's just we're trying to make adjustments on it and try to get used to the track. You know, we've been out for 2.5 months, and it's kind of hard on me and the truck.
Any messages for your Bigfoot 8 fans across the country?
Yeah, I think just hang in there and be patient with me. We'll get back in the winner's circle, I'm sure of it.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot 8.
Scott, I tell you, the problem is not where he thinks it is. The problem is in the left and right movement of the suspension. The hole had nothing to do with it. The rear end is turning. They've got to get that figured out. Now, here's the truck.
Thanks, Arnie. Last week here on Tough Tracks, we all had the first opportunity to see the return of Bigfoot 8. And indeed, it was a return, but one that Andy Brass, driver, I don't think we were really that happy with.
No, we're not. You know, I can say what last week was one of the first weeks we got back in with TNT Monster Truck Racing here, and it wasn't. We went out the second round. We're having a lot of problems trying to get the truck onto the track and stay with it. We're having problems where we're thinking it's part of the track's fault and part of the truck's fault.
Andy, this is a really high-tech truck. Do you think that you put too much modern technology into just plain old racing?
No, I don't think so. I think what a lot of it is, the truck is set up, it's set up loose, you know, and I think what we're doing is the truck is trying to follow the cars too much. We're getting a bad path in the cars, and the truck's just trying to follow the bad path, you know. We're trying to clear all the cars, land on the ramp, and so we can make a good straight run, but our starting line's not back as far as we'd like it to be, so it's, you know, trying to jump over 6-7 cars right off the bat's getting to be hard.
You were really, really squirrely out there. Do you have any idea how to control that tonight?
Yeah, we're thinking we're going to try to lock the rear straight on it tonight, you know, try some stuff into that. We're thinking our rear wheels are pulling us one way or the other. We're getting our bypass valves or maybe getting a little weak, a little old, and they're not holding the steering like they should, so we're going to lock it solid and try to run that way tonight.
Well, good luck to you and the Bigfoot 8 team.
Well, thank you, Chris.
Let's go now back to Scott and Army.
You know, Bigfoot 8 needs to make up some ground in a hurry in the World Championship Truck Race. We're going to check some qualifying round highlights as we see the Bigfoot number 8 truck. And again, remember, Andy Brass was disqualified in his qualification run a week ago, and I think that led to his whole night's worth of trouble.
Yeah, that started a bad nightmare for him, but he and the crew have sat down and they figured it out. They believe the rear end was moving on them. They've locked their rear end off. We're going to find out right now if they made the right move. Brass again. It's there. Look at this. Bigfoot, I think, has found the handle. Now can he find the brake? Yeah, jumps her down.
Fast time in the Bigfoot 8 truck after the problems of a week ago. So Andy Brass is serving notice that just maybe they have found what they need to do a 6:03, by far much faster than anything we saw last week.
Watch how the truck takes off. Andy used the terminology, and I like it. It's like a sponge. When it lands, it sticks. Today, it's landing straight, sticking straight, pulling straight, and winning straight up. Look at that. That was great.
6.76 with a pretty good run for Buffalo Tremor as well, but Bigfoot's run was just awesome.
His equipment stays together, and tonight he's having huge problems.
Well, they're on the Northeast Tour right now. Not a lot of time in between races. You figure about 8 runs a night on an engine combination. It just caught up with him. Meanwhile, Bigfoot, what I want to see is what he's going to do out of the left lane. The first time in 2 weeks we've seen this truck go out of this lane. Let's see how it's going to act. In the right lane, it wanted to go to the right.
He races the Nightlife Chevrolet of Dave Wysorek and puts him away big time.
He cleared. He completely cleared the second set of cars, Scott.
Looks like Andy Brass is back to his old tricks. That's the Andy Brass we saw all winter. That's the Andy Brass we saw drive Bigfoot 4 so aggressively in Louisville.
Good camera angle. Look at this. Boom. Watch the back tire, set it down. He completely cleared. He can't do any better than that.
What a piece of driving by Andy Brass, the driver of Bigfoot. Army's with him right now.
Andy, the truck is making it look easy, but I was watching you on that run, and you are just working your heart out up in there driving this thing. It's going straight, but you're driving it straight, aren't you?
Yes, it is. We have, as you notice, we've had a lot of problems with it driving. You know, we've made some changes today on the truck, and Donnie and I have been working real hard on it. And I think we got the combination back together. It's true that I'm having to work at it, but I don't mind working that little bit if it'll stay going straight.
That's a good camera angle right there. Look at you. You think he's just riding? No. That guy's working.
That's Army with Andy Brass. Now Army's working his way. There are rivalries in sports with certain degrees of dislike. Here's one, friends. These two people don't like each other.
Scott, they just flat hate each other. This is the line on it. Bigfoot thinks Scott Stevens is a crybaby from Texas. Scott Stevens thinks that the Bigfoot team nothing but a bunch of spoiled rich kids with a big Ford truck. But right now, they're both painted blue, and somebody's going to come out of this thing black and blue.
They're trying to psych each other at the starting line.
Don't leave the line as soft as you did last time. He'll try to come off of it pretty hard. And if we get him off the start, maybe you can shake him up and he'll disqualify himself.
Scott, this is Army. You guys look like you're square dancing out there. Everybody's do-si-doing, but nobody's going to the start line. What's the holdup?
Yeah, you know, me and Andy, this is where we both like to be. We like to almost melt each other's motors down playing games, but I'll fix the goal line and do the best we can.
Well, they're playing with each other, and I hope they'll get to the line and let us start a race here, Army.
You know, you can feel the electricity in the air, can't you? Man, this is eerie, what these guys are doing right now. The crowd is just in a hush.
Bigfoot 8, the King Crunch Auto Value Special, about to go head-to-head. Now, we're going to listen to the communications during the race of the Gradio and the King Crunch crew. Let's listen in. Bigfoot getting out of shape between the cars. That's what ended up costing him in his battle with the Auto Value King Crunch. Well, Andy Brass has got it back in the fifth. Chris Chapman is over that way. Let's talk to Andy.
Andy, you and Scott Stevens out there playing mind games before the light turned green.
Yeah, we was messing with it. Scott's been messing with everybody all weekend, you know, so we thought, well, we'd just get up there and play with him a little bit, you know. I think we could probably won the race. We just had a little bit of a problem there between the cars again. The truck wanted to go right and left. You know, we had to slow down, get out of it, correct, and get back in. You know, and just kind of, once we slowed down, Scott caught back up with us, and we just couldn't catch it at the end.
When Bigfoot smacks the retaining wall, you know it's time for the crunch of the week.
The Crunch of the Week is brought to you by Nintendo. With Nintendo, you're playing with power.
How appropriate, the Crunch of the Week features the Auto Value King Crunch in one of his biggest victories as he knocks off Bigfoot.
Yeah, but one of the big stories here is look how hard both drivers drove out the back door. Brad does tag the inside wall at Flemington, New Jersey.
The Crunch of the Week.
Where we even go racing today, though, is on one truck that's not here. The Gravedigger, who won a week ago on Tough Tracks, he'll not have a chance to make it two in a row. Army Armstrong's got that story.
Well, thanks, Scott. As you know, normally this is the portion of the show where we interview the winner of last week's event. That's an impossibility. Last week's event on television was won by Dennis Anderson and Gravedigger. However, since then, in a non-televised event, the truck was completely demolished. Now, Dennis Anderson's okay, but I'm standing with the man that was running him when the accident occurred, Andy Brass, the driver of Bigfoot. Tell me what happened on that run in New York.
Well, it got down to Dennis and I in the finals there, and both of us come off the line about right. We was running pretty well, even across there. I started to pull away, and by the time we got down to the finish line, I looked over and seen Dennis kind of heading off to the left, and I backed out of it and kind of watched him, and all he did was just veered real hard to the left, hit the wall, bounced a few times down the wall, and just really just messed the truck up.
They said the TNT official had to use the killer box, and that's what actually stopped the truck.
Yeah, that's what it was. I think what happened, actually, I think Dennis thumped his head up on the roll bar inside the cab, and it kind of knocked him dizzy there for a little bit, and he just stuffed into the wall.
Well, Andy, everybody's waiting for the return of Bigfoot 8. You came out storming, both barrels smoking, but you're having all kind of problems. You have put a couple of wins under your belt. Tell me what the problems were and how you got them ironed out.
Well, a lot of the problems we've been having with the truck is it's just been wanting to do right hands between the cars there. And every time we come off the cars, it pulls a right-hand turn. A lot of the problems, I think a lot of it was, we're just trying to tarp the truck. I think we might have broke a rocker in the truck, and we're out here on a 10-day tour. It's kind of hard to get parts shipped in, flew out, or whatever, and get them all put in the truck. So we just been backing out of the truck a little bit, trying to drive it easy, you know. We've been turning the fastest times of the night almost every place we go, but still, you know, it's just going to back out, take it easy, and just try to bump the guys.
Well, right now we're going to bump over to Chris Chapman. He talked about a 10-day tour. He's taken two wins on the tour. Chris Chapman's with the driver of USA 1. He's another truck that's taken two wins on this tour.
A few minutes ago got disqualified for going out of the lane. Well, there's the truck they're talking about, Andy Brass, Bigfoot number 8.
You know, in the opening I was talking to Andy, he kept saying the truck is making a right turn in the middle of the jump. Uh-oh, we could have a major problem here. If they don't have that problem solved, we've seen Rambo go against the USA 1 truck. USA 1 had the right turn problem. The Mustang comes out, he's got the right turn problem. Let's see what's going to happen with Bigfoot if they solve that problem. And look who he's going against. Oh, you talk about a battle royal.
Just qualifying, but the Auto Value King Crunch is not hardly running at all. Bigfoot laying down his shot.
Yeah, but Andy was really working up in that truck. If you'll notice, if we have a replay come up, I want you to watch the driver's hand. The truck was going straight, but oh, Andy, buddy, he was working.
I'm going to tell you, Auto Value King Crunch has obviously got some problems and is just going to make a legal pass to get a qualification time. But Andy Brass and Bigfoot, an excellent time. But how about this, an 8.75, only second best. The Carolina Crusher, that old warhorse, is continuing to hang in there. His time is faster than Bigfoot's.
Look at the replay as it comes up. See, Andy, the truck really, from a camera angle, looked like it was going straight, but believe me, that rascal, he had a handful, didn't he, Scott?
Absolutely. Andy Brass taking a beating in the Bigfoot truck.
Thank you.
Scott Stevens already talking about Bigfoot. Bigfoot's got a little business to take care of first, and that is putting away Kid Rarig and the Thunder Chicken, the chicken out of Catawissa, Pennsylvania, taking on Andy Brass and the big, bad Bigfoot number 8.
Watch for the right turn in the middle of the course. If it does not happen, they've got the problem solved. There it is.
He's on the brakes. He's in trouble.
He's got a throttle up. Thunder Chicken may put him away. Oh, God, do you believe that?
Andy Brass all over the course, and Thunder Chicken has upset Bigfoot right here at Lebanon Valley Speedway. A stunning upset.
It's almost like the truck has a mind all its own. It's going to go where it wants to go. Once it comes over the first set of cars, it's almost like it says, right turn, Clyde, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Well, Thunder Chicken will take it, but the sad thing about this is obviously the much superior truck is going to have to go on the trailer or just hope to get back in on a fast loser rule. Thunder Chicken didn't even make an especially good pass, but because Andy Brass can come nowhere close to controlling his truck, Thunder Chicken gets the victory. And, you know, sometimes this sport is more survival than going fast, and the kid did it there. Army is with our survivor. Chris Chapman is over with the guy who's got to be upset about the loss, Andy Brass.
Andy, all you can say about a run like that is it just too wet and floppy out there, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. You know, this is a real sloppy track tonight. As you can see, USA 1 and myself, both, you know, some of the fastest trucks around here, we're not doing nothing out here. You know, it's just too much motor, too much wheel speed. You're noticing that the underdog trucks, the guys not running no horsepower, the big cleated tires and stuff, they're doing a lot better, you know, because they don't need the horsepower in the hole, or they don't have the horsepower between the cars, and where we got the horsepower and the wheel speed, and it's just killing us.
I saw while, you tried everything in the world to get that thing back under control and try it again. It just didn't work for you.
That's right. It's just like being on ice out there. You know, you just step on a little bit and it just wants to pass you up and you just can't hardly correct it. You know, every time you do something, it's you're counter-reacting what the truck's trying to do.
What do you think? Equalizer, this could be a chance for him to gain some more in the points championship against you.
Yes, it is. You know, Equalizer's been running real good tonight. You know, he laid down a real good straight run, a fast run, one of the fastest ones of the night. So he might do real well. But then again, one of the other dogs, one of the underdog trucks might come up and knock him out early too.
Well, good luck, team. We'll see you next week on Tough Track.
All right, thank you, Chris.
Andy Brass definitely put everything in perspective. This track has become a great equalizer. The one thing Bob Chandler and Everett Jasper can't plan for when they're putting these huge state-of-the-art trucks together is a track. So Steve Wilkie, right to the point. I tell you, I do like that about Steve Wilkie. He, you know, if there's something wrong with the equipment, he tells us. But if he makes a mistake, he's the first one to come tell you, hey, I blew it.
Yeah, and also he brought out something else, something that's mandatory in a good racer. He wasn't watching the other guy. He drives his own race. Now, speaking of own race, truck in the right lane's had nothing but troubles. Man, he's fast, but oh, he's got a cut around shot. A big bad right.
Look at this. These will be the top two times of the night. Bigfoot Fast Qualifier and the Outlaw will be number two.
And they're good times. That means that's the way they're going to have to be paired off. What a driving job of that kid out of Missouri, though.
7.49 for Bigfoot, 8.06 for the Outlaw. What a run by these two Fords. And look, Bigfoot even had to get out of it for a second.
Yeah, he backpedaled at mid-track, punched the throttle, and right turn, Clyde, just like last week. I don't know why that truck does that.
I don't know why it didn't go over. He was really cocked.
Those spectators don't know why it does it either.
I'm going to tell you, watch it again as Bigfoot starts to slide. And a lot of times when trucks start to get up on those two wheels, they go on over. But the Bigfoot truck came back to Andy Brass here. Man, he was perilously close to going over. Chris Chapman has caught up with Andy Brass. Let's see what he's got to say.
Andy, you got a little squirrely off the first set of cars. You got hit on the second set of cars, and you still had the fast time.
Yeah, it is. You know, it just goes to prove the truck will run when it does, when we can hit the cars right, you know. It's first time in that lane, you know. I'm just trying to check it out. The track seems a little slick on top, but you can see at the end there when I just started sliding. You know, it's nothing we can do about it right now.
Looked like you were going over.
Yeah, I kind of thought we was there for a little bit. I was just hoping that they didn't pull the kill switch on me and kill me because I was still trying to steer it under fire.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot in good shape as the fast qualifier. He's going to get a five run. Let's look at Outlaw and Mike Wine. Bigfoot number 8, revolutionary, state-of-the-art, brand new suspension. They call it a cantilever suspension, and it actually gives Bigfoot the kind of suspension travel that no other truck has ever had in this sport.
This is a truck that brought all the controversy into the sport this year. They actually made them, yes, they made them keep this truck away from the races for 2 months in order to give these other trucks a chance to catch up. Rambo's going up against Bigfoot 8. Look at the difference. New truck on the left. Wow, Andy Brass. Oh, here we go again.
Squirrely at the end again, but I'm just wondering how fast he could get on this track. That was a lightning run.
I'm kind of waiting to find out. Yeah, we're at the end trying to get a time on this. It wasn't only quick, it was smooth.
Andy Brass and the Bigfoot Ford putting on a show. And he almost put on a show with the wall earlier, in case you missed the start of the show today. He actually smacked that wall at the end of the run. This time, he got it stopped a little short of it.
Yeah, but look at the, everywhere you go, this still has to be probably one of the most popular monster trucks in the world. We got a replay coming up now. The mid-range is stay straight. That's all he needs
to get a big victory. Bigfoot, your winner. Here's Andy Brass with Army.
Andy, we just get the word, Andy, at 7:33. That's quick time of the night. You made it look easy. That's the truck end of it. I was watching you, and you were working up in there.
Yeah, I am. You know, it just seems like the truck's wanting to pull, and I'm just, you know, really having to fight it to stay straight. You know, it's something that we've been having a problem with all along, you know, but as long as I can hold her straight, you know, we're going to keep laying down some fast times.
Last week it was always going to the left. Tonight it's always going to the right. What's the difference?
Well, we're lining up a little bit on the cars. I think the cars are staying up tonight a little bit better than what they have been, and it's pitching us just a little bit one way or the other.
You look at the state-of-the-art Bigfoot, the new wave. Well, what you're seeing here are a couple of the old guard trucks. These guys have been
It was either transmission or an oil pan. I couldn't tell which one. But what happened when the drive shaft exploded? It went up into the bottom of the engine. So they've definitely got some kind of a problem, either in the transmission or the engine. Now, speaking of a guy that does not have a problem so far, Look who's coming to the line, the Big Blue.
After the problems he had a week ago here, you know, Bob Chandler and Andy Brass have really got to feel good about the way that they've been able to figure this course out and get it back under control. Because last week they looked terrible, and today they look awesome.
Well, they look bad right now. Look at this. They are bumping that Carolina Crusher, and what happens at the end? Again, it hangs to the right. And that doesn't matter. Once you go across the finish line, you can do loop-de-loos if you want, because you're going to the next round. That's got to be in the back of his mind that truck's going to react that way, Scott.
Carolina Crusher has been strong and fast for 2 weeks here on Tough Tracks, and he just got completely blown away by Bigfoot number 8 and Andy Brass.
Yeah, Brass just thumped him right on the start line. He drilled him right from the get-go. Look at that. Now, again, notice how straight the truck is until it comes off the finish line into the track, and it hooks right on him.
Yeah, but he's able to keep it straight. And I'm going to tell you, Bigfoot looks absolutely awesome tonight. One more look at it as Andy Brass puts away Gary Porter's Carolina Crusher. Now he's over with Army.
Andy, all night long, you and your crew chief have been going back and tweaking the truck, fine-tuning, and it's going straight as an arrow for you now.
That's right. You know, Donnie and I, we've been working all week on the truck. We've been having a lot of problems. It's pulling to the right. We think we got it under control tonight, though. So we've just been lining up on the line and pulling it, and it's been working pretty straight. We're having to work at it, but it's been doing us a good job.
Have any preference to who you want to go against in the final, or does it make any difference to this type of competition?
It don't really make any difference right now.
Andy and Army talking about the crew chief for the Bigfoot truck. Donnie comes over with a big handshake right there. He's going to take a look to make sure his truck's okay.
You know, these crew chiefs are real important. Kevin Ford, he really helps Scott Stevens. Donnie, he does some driving for the Bigfoot operation, but it's getting to the point now. If you're going to stay on this tour, you're going to have to take a crew with you.
King Crunches. This is what it's come down to at Lebanon Valley Speedway on Tough Tracks. Bigfoot number 8, Andy Brass, St. Louis, Missouri, driving for the most famous name in monster truck racing, Bob Chandler's Bigfoot stable. Against him, the Auto Value King Crunch out of Woodlands, Texas. Another warrior who's been around this sport a long time. Scott Stevens, outstanding operation. He came in with a computerized setup a year ago, state-of-the-art in that respect, while Bob Chandler designed a state-of-the-art chassis. And that's what we're seeing, not only these two different philosophies about monster truck racing, but also two guys who don't like each other. Scott Stevens has spent all year bad-mouthing the new Bigfoot truck, and Andy Brass just wants to hammer him every time he can.
Well, what we're going to have here, you notice they're playing mind games with each other, trying to jockey around, get a little bit of heat in the engine. What are you going to see at Lebanon Valley right now, Scott? Battle of the Blues.
But it's not the Blues Brothers, I'll tell you that.
These guys are not even first cousins, believe me.
Bigfoot has been gaining points on Equalizer all night because King Crunch, the Auto Value Special, actually did Bigfoot a favor earlier tonight. Of course, he was doing more for himself by getting the victory. Here we go, it's showtime!
He was out of shape at half track at costing Bigfoot. Takes a big win, Scott.
Army, when we watch the replay, Value King Crunch had a shot to win this race at halfway. If he could have stayed straight, he was right there with Bigfoot. But when he got squirrely, it was all over.
We've been talking about Bigfoot having problems between the jumps. The problem this time landed on the other blue truck. Stevens with the Auto Value a little bit out of shape, had the back on the throttle. That gave Bigfoot a chance to literally leap to the very, very popular win.
Look at Andy Brass. He's hanging out the window, kind of just riding on the side, and they love him here in New York.
Hey, this victory's been a long time coming. It's well deserved. Let's watch the replay. It comes up again.
Now, again, the key to this race is Scott Stevens in between the two sets of cars.
Right.
They're even.
Here, he's in trouble. That's the race.
They were even until that, and he had to get out of the throttle. And, boy, you cannot make any mistake against Andy Brass and Bigfoot number 8. Here we come again.
Watch out. Love these replays. He gives you a couple times to see. In the background, you see Kevin Ford come around, Scott Stevens' crew chief. He's watching, but Stevens, as soon as he gets in trouble, that's it.
Andy Brass, your winner. Here's Armin.
All right, this was a night, Andy, that you guys were looking for, being the Bigfoot team, and the other guys were not. You got the truck running straight. You got it handling good. What about the points chase now? Can you pull these guys in that are in front of you? And there's only one of them.
That's right. Equalizer's been ahead of us. From what I've been following, he's only roughly, I don't know, 30, 40 points maybe. But we have another couple shows to go. And if we can keep her straight. And, you know, tonight we had a perfect night. It was 25 points. We pull a couple more of them off. It won't take us long to catch him.
Can you do it? Yes or no?
Yeah, I think so. I think the Ford acclaim running the way it is tonight and stuff, I think we'll catch him here in a couple shows.
Andy Brass sounding very confident. Mentioned a perfect night, 25 points. That means he was fast qualifier, won every race. And indeed, that perfect night helped him chop down that lead the equalizer has. The difference.
Continue their battle for the world championship on tough tracks in the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. So we talk about the battle for the world championship. 1 week ago, Bigfoot made up a lot of ground when he beat the Auto Value King Crunch in the Monster Smash Final. Andy Brass is trying to chase down Greg Holbrook and the Equalizer and bring that world championship for the first time into the Ford camp with the new Bigfoot number 8. Chris Chapman is with Andy Brass right now.
Thanks, Scott. The return of Bigfoot 8 was something that most monster truck racers really weren't looking forward to after it being banned earlier in the year, while the other trucks here bring their trucks up to his competitive standards. But Andy Brass, the driver of Bigfoot 8, the return really hasn't turned out like you expected, has it?
No, it hasn't. We've been having a lot of problems with 8. You know, we come back, we was out for 2.5 months. We missed a lot of shows with the truck, and that really hurt us because it's hard to dial a truck in outdoors and out to the outdoor tracks when you're not out running with everybody every weekend. So when we come back out, you know, we was already behind in a point stand, and we had to try to catch back up, try to get the truck to work out, and it's just a lot of stuff we're having to cram in 1 or 2 weeks of racing, and it's really hard to do, and we're having a little bit of problem with it right now.
When we first saw Bigfoot 8, it was indoors, and this truck was just dynamite. Do you think you're really just not acclimating well to outdoors?
Yeah, it's hard to say, really. You know, when you're indoors, your tracks are pretty well the same from week to week. And outdoors, the track changes so much. You know, we've been on a lot of outdoor tracks. We've been having a lot of problem with the weather. It's been raining on us. The truck's not handling, you know, very good. We run the cut tires, and they're showing a lot of problems in the mud tracks. And then we get on tracks like what we've got here tonight and stuff. And, you know, one lane gets a little bit bad, you get a rut in it, your truck's going to follow the rut, or you get on the starting line, and what we have out here is just powder. It's not a good traction. We're spinning off the line. We're not going nowhere.
Well, good luck tonight, Andy, and we'll see if Bigfoot 8's luck changes later tonight. Back to you, Scott.
Okay, Chris, let's take a look at the situation in terms of points, because that's what it's all about in the battle for the 1990 TNT Monster Truck Challenge World Championship. Now, remember, Bigfoot 8, while sitting out, was still getting some points because Bigfoot 4's points were counting. So certainly Andy Brass is very much in the hunt. The difference is 18. That's the lead Equalizer has over the Bigfoot camp heading into today's action. Carolina Crusher's not out of the tank booth. Chris Chapman reporting from the pits, and we'll be checking in later with Mike Goss, who's trackside, to talk to all the drivers after their runs tonight on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. In Stafford Spring, Connecticut, we're about to go into first round competition, but Army thought we'd take a look at one more qualifying highlight. Bigfoot 8 and Equalizer, and this is kind of a, you know, it's not a race, not an elimination race, but it is one where they can feel each other out.
Believe me, neither one wanted a little look at Brass. Comes out, pulls the trigger out of the left lane. The truck looks pretty good for him, but they're still having a problem. I've got a theory on what their problem is with that truck. I'm going to explain to you a little bit later. But the chassis is what we call unloading on the truck when it lands. Okay? Chassis is all tightened up with a jet gear. Andy's when he leaves the line, it's just straight as an arrow. But as soon as he backs on the throttle when it lands, that chassis unloads and goes where it darn well
now
leaves.
We get to the Ford showdown between Bigfoot 8 and the Outlaw. So apparently the tire repaired at least enough to race.
Scott, one of the things I was trying to point out to you, when the truck's sitting on the start line, they can load the chassis. That driver does that with the brake and the gas. It's loaded right now. The chassis still loaded. Now it unloads, and look what happens.
When
you got to drive it back.
A huge upset. Bigfoot's in some trouble. He gets it shut down. The Outlaw has again beaten Bigfoot. Mike Wine knocks off the Big Daddy in the Ford camp, and the Outlaw team is pumped up with another huge win over Bigfoot, and this time they knock off the Bigfoot 8 truck. But watch the story of this race. Andy Brass has to get on the brakes right there.
He was on the brakes, believe me, the old tripod Outlaw was on full boogaloo, and that's what pays dividends in this sport. Look at the end of the run, Brass was really trying to drive it hard, but the chassis, like I say, I've watched his truck, they've talked about it, I guarantee you, when they get that chassis to stay tight, the truck will go straight as an arrow.
Between the cars was the demise of Bigfoot, and you saw the margin of victory there for Mike Wine and the Outlaw team out of Pensauken, New Jersey.
nothing gets Mike more fired up than a win over Bigfoot. Chris Chapman is going to talk to Andy Brass about that run.
Andy, when you keep it straight, you win, and when you don't, you don't.
Yeah, that's right, and we're just having problems. We've been watching everybody, though. You know, everybody's having a little bit of problem in this left-hand lane, but you know, that's the lane we chose. I was trying to watch the starting line in the right lane, and it didn't look like it was, you know, everybody was getting as good as grab off the line. We figured, well, we'll just stay in the left lane. We'll get good hole shot on them, but it's having problems with the truck between the cars again.
Well, it's a precision sport as much as a power sport for some of these tracks. Bigfoot, being fast qualifier, gained 4 points in that round. But because Bigfoot lost in the first round, despite the fact that he gets to come back, and Equalizer won, Equalizer gains 2 more points. What's it all mean? At this moment, Equalizer leads Bigfoot by 16 points in the battle for the world championship. But now they go head to head.
Well, really what it all means is the Blues boys are going at it one more time. Kick back and watch.
Impressive, Scott. Look at here. Bigfoot is just having all kinds of problems with this race course. Equalizer gets the win, and at least for the moment, the points difference right now is what it started tonight. Equalizer by 18.
Yeah, but the Equalizer still has another round he can go through, right? So he can stretch the point out. I'm amazed that Holbrook literally had this thing covered from the get-go.
Wow. Great run for the Equalizer, but again, Bigfoot with big problems in between the cars. Mike Goss is down right now with driver Greg Holbrook of the Equalizer. The world championship, the guy who's chasing him is Andy Brass. A tough loss for him in that round, and Chris Chapman's going to go over and talk to Andy about the run.
Andy, maybe that lane change wasn't the right choice.
I guess it wasn't, you know. It just seems like they put the starting line right there is on asphalt, and they laid about 6-8 inches of dirt on it. It seems like all we did is just bite right through the dirt, hit the asphalt, and just turned sideways on us.
This week's power drop to the controversy. The Auto Value King Crunch was at the starting line. Equalizer could have staged and gone. Instead, he backed off. The TNT officials backed the trucks away. Bigfoot now comes back, and I'm going to tell you this right now. If this season championship is decided by 3 points or less and Bigfoot wins it, Gary Cook is going to be pulling this tape back up to see what happens and how Bigfoot gets a free ride right here.
Yeah, this is your 3 points.
Will not be any more than 3 points, and the Auto Value King Crunch gets the last laugh anyway because he beats Bigfoot.
So we've got an all Chevrolet final set up. North Carolina be going against Texas. Look how hard they're driving these trucks.
Let me make this point, Army Armstrong. Bigfoot ran tonight in 3 races. He lost them all. Equalizer ran 2, won them both. Bigfoot's going to gain points for the night.
The ironic thing, Gary Cook is the one that made the call to back off the line. Had they gone to the line and run, no matter what, how slow it was, they would have gotten a point. If they would have done what Kong did, they would still be a player.
Instead, Bigfoot gains ground. And in the whole process, Scott Stevens, the Auto Value King Crunch, says, I'm going to the bottom. Our Bigfoot 8 and the Equalizer. Bigfoot 8 comes in tonight, trailing by 15 points in the season standing. Where do you pick up points to start tonight? In qualifying. And what Bigfoot wants to do is be fast qualifier. Something that should inspire him even more. The truck he lines up against, Army Armstrong, beat him head-to-head a week ago. Outlaw got a win over Bigfoot, and Mike Wine was quick to crow about it.
You know, this is the point of the year when deja vu racing takes over. Everybody's had a shot at somebody else all year long. The big thing right now, Mike Wine and his mind.
Obviously, the Outlaw is not at 100% tonight, but Bigfoot lays down a superb shot, and that's going to be the fast time in qualification. 7.13 in Army, that is significantly faster than any time we saw on this track a week ago.
One thing that's interesting, last week the right lane was not the place to be. This week, that might be the ticket, if you will. Look at this. Andy Brass is smooth, and the truck, like Chris Chapman said, when you go straight, you're going to go to the next round. He went straight as an arrow. Have they solved the problem? We may find out tonight.
They pay the big bucks and the season point fund at the end of the year. Andy Brass and the Bigfoot Ford out of St. Louis, Missouri, and he knows this other truck well. It may have a new paint job, the Wild Hair, but to him, it's the old stomper, a guy he's seen many times, Marvin Smith out of Arnold, Missouri.
Andy Brass had a handle on it qualifying. By handle, I mean he went straight. Can he do it they found the problem, Scott.
Bigfoot looks so good when he can go straight. What looks like something underneath.
Yeah, they've got some safety loops. He may have had a drive shaft getting a safety loop, but no major problem. The big question that was just answered is, look, Andy Brass, when he lands, is going straight. That's about like telling your neighbor he's going to have a toothache in about an hour and a half.
Still, it appears the starting line's a problem for him with that thin layer of dirt on top of the asphalt. Let's go to Mike Goss, who's with Andy Brass.
Andy, looks like you got your handling problem straightened out.
Yeah, it looked like the truck was running pretty good tonight. You know, the only thing I'm really concerned about is the start line. As long as we can get a good launch off the line and they keep packing it before every round, I think we're gonna do pretty good tonight.
So the problem is loose dirt on the asphalt down there?
Yeah, they don't have a whole lot of dirt. They only got about 2 to 3 inches, you know, and if they don't keep packing it, the problem is a lot of guys are just breaking loose, and then you sit on top of the asphalt, and with a little bit of dirt there, it's just like sitting on ice.
Second set of cards is no problem, is it?
It's not. You know, once if we can keep this thing going straight, you know, and keep under the fire, you know, the 14 or 15 cars, we're going to be able to just launch right over them.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I'm going to tell you something. Andy Brass is a racer, and he walked out of here a week ago Army embarrassed that he had lost 3 times, and he got his act together, and that Bigfoot team has come to play today.
Yeah, when he came back in the building, so to speak, to this week, he and his mechanic were the hunter killers of this sport. They were going after each and every one of these other monster trucks, and that round just proved it.
Carol, the superstars of monster truck racing move to the quarterfinal round and a key battle in the standings for the TNT World Championship. Bigfoot, second in the season points, hoping to track that equalizer for number one, but hey, he better not look over his shoulder. Carolina Crusher sits third and would love to beat him here to try and track him down for second.
There's a little added incentive here. Carolina Crusher gets beat, which he did. That's the last time you're going to see Gary Porter in that truck. You just saw a little bit of motorsport history go down the tubes right there as Bigfoot takes the win.
Again, that truck is sold, and Gary Porter will be coming right back with a brand new truck.
Yeah, but Porter goes over and salutes the crowd and says, thank you for your support. That's been a good truck for him, hasn't it?
It sure has. It's been a great truck. He carried him to the number 2 spot in the World Championship a year ago. He's running 3rd right now. And again, when he brings his new truck out, the points that he accumulates in that new truck next week will continue to go right along with the old truck. TNT rules allow you 1 truck change per season. The winner was Andy Brass.
Tell us about that run, Andy.
Well, this run was a little bit different. You know, we weren't as hard coming off the line. The truck did pull a little bit to the right side, but, you know, it was coming good off the first set of cars. I just kind of let out of it a little bit and then got back in it, and the truck pulled straight pretty fast. So I wasn't real happy with it, but it wasn't a bad run.
Well, we'll see if he's sentimental at all. Gary taking you into the semifinal round at Stafford Springs, Connecticut. Now, Army, 2 critical points to the semifinal race between Bigfoot and No Problem. You got to watch the start because Bigfoot has had a lot of problems getting started with only a couple inches of dirt on top of this asphalt. And then coming off the first set of cars, Bigfoot has had several problems handling himself in between the sets. Watch his start and then watch him off that first set of cars.
I think there's another point we got to bring out here. That's the yellow truck sitting in the lane next to him. John Moore has a confidence tonight I have not seen before. Andy Brass better not take him lightly.
And John has kept his truck straight throughout the night. That could be a big factor with the noted squirrely handling problems that Bigfoot has had in 2 weeks of racing at Stafford Springs, Connecticut.
One thing for sure, when that light goes green, we're going to find out. We're going to wash all these problems right now.
The semifinals, a big lead.
In trouble, Moore comes back. John Moore, that's going to be one of the biggest wins of his career. Moore beat number 8.
I'm going to tell you, the giant killer, John Moore, is having the night of his racing career. He knocks off Bigfoot.
Did you think it could happen? I love it. I don't know whether it could or not, but it just did, and I love it.
Look, John Moore's on a roll. His wife Heidi, his daughter Jill, they're here. You talk about pump. You talk about destiny, we might be seeing it right now.
Well, we're going to look at it again, Army. And we talked about coming off the cars. Watch Bigfoot. He's in trouble again right here.
And Bigfoot is out, a complete truck. He has the back truck, back pedal. When he does, John Moore is standing there with a big grin on his face and says, I'm going home.
Before the race, we talked about John Moore was going to give it a nice, straight, hard shot.
Yeah, fuel last round tonight. But, oh, boy, I got an air bubble or something, but came back to life in the middle, and it worked real good.
Can you win this thing?
Well, I don't know. I'm going to sure give it a shot. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
Hey,
You know, we talked about the fact that John Moore earlier had never beaten Bigfoot 8. He can take that off his record now. He has a straight up, no doubt about it, victory over the Bigfoot 8 truck. Now, we're getting worried that the Bigfoot camp is upset about the fact that the track crew watered the track to keep the dust down before this race. Let's go to Chris Chapman and see what she can find out about that.
Andy, it looked like that first set of cars was your downfall.
Nah, I don't know. You know, we come off the first car, we took it a little easy. You know, we wanted to come out and make sure we're straight, but we got in between the cars, grabbed third gear and hit it hard. And right before we went out to run, they watered the track down, and water on grass, you know what that makes. You know, we just slid out. I don't know why they watered it. You know, they should have did it. If they was going to do it, they should have did it earlier.
I noticed that they were out there watering. Do you think that played a definite factor?
Yeah, it did. You know, I mean, we wasn't having no problem between the cars there all night long. And like I say, right 2 minutes before you go out and run, they water down the track. And, you know, it's just, I don't know what the idea of it was for. Sometimes you think they're all against you.
Well, obviously, an upset Bigfoot camp. I don't know if that's a case of sour grapes, possibly. You know, you got to consider the fact that both trucks, well, here you see a replay. Earlier, they did indeed water the track down, but both trucks had to run on that same facility, that same track, the same conditions. Chris Chapman. In a moment, but first, Army Armstrong, we are ready to have the third world champion crowned. 2 years ago, USA won and Bigfoot came down to the wire. USA won it here at Louisville, Kentucky's Freedom Hall. Last year, David Morris took the equalizer to the championship again in this building. And this time around, the equalizer with its new driver, Greg Holbrook, Andy Brass, and Bigfoot, one of them leaves Louisville next week with the championship.
The only thing for sure when they pull out of the Bluegrass State is a blue truck will be a world champion. There's been so much controversy in 1990 with the penalty given to Bigfoot crew, them having to come back with adversity, John Pyant filling in. There's almost a Hollywood drama there. Then you got this rookie coming over, and you call him a rookie only because it's his first year driving. This kid has turned out to be a seasoned veteran in about 5 short months.
That, of course, is Greg Holbrook, who hopes to put the equalizer back in the championship circle. The Bigfoot 8 controversy certainly was the story throughout the middle portion of the year. That truck actually banned because it was too good.
Yeah, it's a strange case in motorsports, but technology had to be slowed down. The promoters decided they wanted Bigfoot to sit on the shelf for about 2 months in order to let the other trucks catch up, and that is exactly what happened, because when they brought the Bigfoot 8 back, and Andy Brass did such a great job of driving it, everybody was in the ballpark. They had all caught him. Then they squared off to find out who the world champion is going to be, and that's where we're going to find out this week in Louisville.
These two state-of-the-art trucks battling to improve their position, one or two spots, but certainly all eyes are focused on this man right here. Can Andy Brass and Bigfoot 8 overtake Greg Holbrook's equalizer at Freedom Hall in Louisville? Let's check out qualifying highlights. Bigfoot running at the same time as Dave Wisorek's Nightlife Chevrolet. The Nightlife's a good test for Andy Brass, Army Armstrong, because when he gets up the side of it qualifying, he can get a feel on how the other trucks are going to react to this course in Louisville.
Yeah, he knows why Sorry's going to run him hard. Look at Bigfoot. Bigfoot is dialed in Louisville. He is loaded for bear. There's no doubt about it. He literally flew over the finish line.
Yes, indeed. Bigfoot looking solid coming into tonight's action at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. 4.72, the fast time goes to Bigfoot. This week's Power Drive is brought to you by Nintendo's Game Boy, where every shift of the gears brings to you more games and excitement. Whenever you feel the need to be in control, reach for Game Boy from Nintendo, your power to go. And Bigfoot has flat got the power to go on the Nintendo Power Drive.
Andy Brashaw and the Bob Chandler Air Force has arrived in Louisville.
Chris Chapman is standing by with Bigfoot's Andy Brass. Chris?
That ramp looked like it shot you pretty far up in the air.
Yeah, it did. You know, I was looking at the track earlier tonight, you know, and we was kind of watching the left lane because we figured that's what we was going to end up in. And the left lane's ramp did look a little steeper, and it was. It put us right up in the air.
So what do you think the ramp might, if you have to run there on tonight, do you think that could damper your chances of winning?
Yeah, it could slow us down a little bit, but I'm trying to watch the race a little bit. It looked like we might have landed about the finish line.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot were so dominant in the winter months indoors. Now, after having some problems outside, we're back indoors. Bigfoot made this brand new Carolina Crusher.
Got something
Look at what they're doing. Bigfoot has lane choice, and where does he go? Into the lane he hasn't run all night long. He's trying to get a handle on both sides of the track, so if he does meet the equalizer in the next round, he'll have a handle on him. And whatever he's holding looks like it could be the win at hand tonight, Scott.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot continues to lay down shot after shot. That was his fastest shot of the night at 4.66 on that run. Let's look at it again, and Andy Brass has flat got this track dialed in.
Okay, now he's coming over the hump. You can see every run, the confidence factor is building because he attacks the initial hump, goes quick, first time out of the right lane.
Dave Weissdorf's nightlife seems to put down a decent shot, but boy, Andy Brass is just dominant, it looks like, tonight at Louisville, Kentucky. And, well, this is kind of a throwback to some of the indoor events that were run in the early part of the year when this Bigfoot 8 truck looked so good and so strong and had a big part to play in his banishment for a couple of months. Here's Army with Andy Brass.
All right.
Andy, this thing's kind of winding down the way we're looking at it. You've done what you have to do. If Holbrook can do what he has to do, you're going to go against him in this next round.
Yeah, it is. You know, I've been kind of watching it. Gary, Greg's been running real well with the truck and all, but like I said, I think the Acclaim Ford's been running good for us, and I think we can take her tonight.
Well, if you're going to get this kid, the earlier you get him, the better off you are as far as these points.
That's right. You know, the earlier we can knock him out or he can knock us out, you know, the points are real critical for both of us this time, and so whoever can go out early, you know, it's going to help the other guy out a lot.
Andy Brass knows what lies in front of him, a probable meeting with Equalizer in the semifinals, and while no certain race is for the world championship, this is going to be as close as you can. The semifinals at Louisville Freedom Hall. There's this matchup, then there's another week of racing, but certainly the winner right here in the semifinals is going to take a major step toward the world championship. Bigfoot and Equalizer. Equalizer comes into this race with a 2-point lead, so the winner of this race will take the season points lead. Chris talked a little earlier with Greg Holbrook.
Greg, this run in the semifinal run is a biggie. It's between you and Bigfoot, and it could decide the world title.
Yeah, this is going to be a real close race, but you're just going to have to pretend like just anybody else out there running, run your own race, let him do what he wants to. He might mess up.
That's the word from Equalizer's Greg Holbrook. Also in the pits a few moments ago, Chris took a moment to talk with Andy Brass, the driver of Bigfoot, about what certainly will be the biggest race so far in his monster truck racing career.
Andy Brass, this could be very well the biggest race of your life. It's between you and Equalizer, and it's a quest for that national points title.
Yes, it is. You know, the Acclaim Ford's been running real well for us tonight. We're kind of watching it, watching the track, and Greg's been doing real well with his truck tonight, you know. We're watching, you know, I'm trying to run the truck hard, but not run it hard enough where I'm going to break it or anything. You know, we got one more race. It's two races, and both of them is big points. We're figuring maybe we can just lay low a little bit with the truck, save it, make two good shows instead of one killer show, and collect more points that way. We're just, like I say, we're just kind of playing the odds right now, watching how everything goes, and, you know, we're trying to watch Equalizer. We're just going to run hard enough to beat him.
Army, what's going on with lane choice now?
I don't know. Bigfoot pushes the Equalizer.
Questions. First off, we're going to find out what's wrong with the Equalizer, but the other question, mind games from Andy Brass. He forced Equalizer into the lane he had not run in tonight.
I don't believe that the truck not running is a result of that, but he made this rookie think for a minute. Andy Brass has been holding the hot hand all night long. He's been playing mind games, and he's a new national points leader.
He is, and that may be the biggest race in his quest for the world championship. Army is trackside with Andy Brass.
Andy, you can actually feel the electricity in the air. Was there more pressure on you for that run than any run this year?
Yeah, it probably is. Like I said, you know, the points are getting so close that we really need them. And as we was coming into this round, I was just behind him just a little bit. So I figured, well, if I can get him this round, knock him out early, and keep on going, maybe we'll go ahead and get it to show.
Army, you might want to stay down at that part of the track. We're hearing that Equalizer thinks the kill box malfunctioned.
Okay, we're keeping an eye. The crew's going over. They're going to look at the kill box. Now, this is a safety feature. We're going to look for lights. A green light means everything's okay. A red light means there is a malfunction. TNT personnel's checking it out. Scott, I don't know.
And Mike Speller is the head tech man. He is down there looking into things right now. I don't know if we can hear any of the conversation. Let's listen.
A lot of discussion going on with the track crew. Can't do anything about it.
Well, right there you heard Mike Speller say he could not do anything about it. And indeed, the win will stand for Bigfoot. Chris is caught up with Gary. The finalists at Freedom Hall in Louisville,
Kentucky. The monster smash, and Bigfoot's done it again. He's forcing Carolina Crusher into the other lane after Crusher had run off the left side all night.
Tom, what you're going to be looking at is the Chevrolet Ford New Wave Final. This is a new technology, and it all winds up in the final shot of the night in Louisville, Kentucky.
Carolina Crusher and Gary Porter, a truck that has just been out for a few weeks and really our first chance to look at it on TV. He goes after Bigfoot, but he didn't get him. Bigfoot wins it here, and that gives him even more championship points.
We're down to one race to go next week on Top Track. Can Bigfoot hold on to be the world champion? Man, if he does, he came from nowhere to do it.
But he's going to go in with a solid advantage, and really, it is now Bigfoot's world championship to win and Bigfoot's world championship to lose. That man, Andy Brass, is in control.
Congratulated by his crew. Andy, make it real short and sweet. In order to be the world champion, all you have to do is show up in Louisville, Kentucky next week.
Yeah, that's right, you know. It's going to be a good run. You know, like I say, the acclaimed Ford's been running good for us. You know, we just run just as hard as we needed to run tonight, tried to save the truck. We got one more race, like you say, for the points. And we wasn't, like I say, we wasn't pushing hard early because there was no need to. We're trying to save the truck and make sure we make a good run here next week.
Let me ask you a question about the incident with the kill box. What happened out there?
Well, that's hard to say. You know, I wasn't running, you know, I wasn't in Greg's truck or anything. It's an incident that happens once in a while. It's happened three or four times throughout the year. But, you know, these boxes are mechanical. Things go wrong and they go out, you know. It's hard to say. It's a tough decision to make. But, you know, if they was going to do that, they should have did it earlier in the year. And if they was going to let the guys run over, it's just a thing. My box, I got the first box tonight. When I put it in, kept falling out, and I was just like, I need a new box. You know, it's up to the driver's responsibility to look at the box and make sure it's going to stay in there and stay on. You know, some of these boxes have been, they've been run all year. They're starting to get old, wore out. You know, they're not fitting right. So it's a lot the driver has to take that in consideration when he runs, that he should check his box.
Next week, you could be the world champion. Good luck to you.
Well, thank you, Army.
A major step in Louisville's Freedom Hall taken on this Tough Track edition by Andy Brass and Bigfoot. He now has the points lead by 4 over Greg Holbrook's equalizer. Bigfoot's just going to try to tread water and keep up with and not get hurt early against equalizer next week. Crusher, Crunch.
Hi again, everyone. I'm Scott Douglas, and the 1990 world champion on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge is about to be crowned right here on Tough Tracks. Standing by is the man who hopes to put the big trophy on the mantelpiece after tonight's races. That's Bigfoot's Andy Brass. And Andy, coming in, you got the points lead. What's the strategy on this final night of the year?
Well, I think the strategy tonight we're going to do is just going to kind of run about as fast as we need to on qualifying, try to get first in qualifying so we can build up ourselves and some points. And then just kind of lay low a little bit until we got it up against the big gun like Equalizer and Carolina Crusher. If we can make it that far, then we're just going to just run her as hard as we can. It's going to be the last show for us and everything. And we kind of saved it last week in Louisville, trying to prepare the truck for this race. So now we're just going to let loose with it.
Andy, 2 years ago, Rich Hoosier, driving Bigfoot, came within a half point of the world championship. Is there any extra pressure from you or Bob or the rest of the camp that you really want this one that much worse?
Yeah, we really want it pretty bad. You know, this is the first year we come out with the new truck, Bigfoot H and all. And we kind of laid low a year, took a lot of time to build the truck and everything. Now we come back out and we built a new truck, got a new driver and everything. We just want to take it, you know, like I say, this first year for this truck, first year for me, and we're wanting it pretty bad.
They tried to put things against you, but you sat out the band. Now you may win it. I'm trying to get the last lap here tonight.
Yeah, that's right. You know, the band hurt us. You know, we was out on roughly 2.5-3 months. You know, that really put us back a little bit with the truck. We had to sit back and do some other things, you know, and hope that working in the truck on some other shows, we could work some of the bugs out of it. And coming back right into TNT racing, it took us a little bit. We was having problems with the truck. We had to try to iron them out. And I think we did everything, got everything working pretty good, and the truck's been working well for us here lately, so I'm hoping we can take it tonight.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot trying to win the world championship here tonight. The only truck that can beat him for the world title is the Equalizer Chevrolet and Greg Holbrook. Now, according to the Equalizer camp, 1 week ago here on Tough Tracks, they were robbed because of a killer radio box. With more on that story, here's Chris Chapman and team owner Gary Cook.
Qualification round.
Thanks,
Army,
Scott.
We'll see Bigfoot try to get the number one spot right off the bat.
Well, you know, during the interview you had a moment ago with Andy Brass, he was talking about being out for about 2 months. They were not racing for 2 months. This truck was not sitting on a shelf. They were doing a lot of research and development with it. They can still go quick and go fast. This qualifying shot is very, very important to him. If it gives him quick time, it'll give him lane choice all night long. And Scott, have you seen many times this year, lane choice can pay dividends at the end of the night.
It'll also give him more points toward what he hopes will be a world championship at the end of this program. Bennett Clark and Clydesdale qualifying at the same time, but not in Bigfoot's league, as Andy Brass lays down an outstanding shot at 4.33 seconds, and that certainly is one that's going to be tough to beat.
And watch how smooth the truck is. He really comes over that first jump a little bit wild, gets it way up in the air, but like you said, last shot out of the box, this guy is pumped up tonight.
Andy Brass and Bigfoot, there you see it, 4.33. A pretty good time for Bennett Clark.
Ready for
first round action on the TNT Monster Truck Challenge from Louisville's Freedom Hall. It'll be Bigfoot against Wildhair. But in the pits, Chris has found out that Equalizer has more problem than just a kill box. Let's go to Chris, who is in a frantic Equalizer pit.
Greg, this appears to be a little bit more than a kill box problem.
Yeah, the fuel pump wasn't pumping any fuel, but the kill box...
This is a new problem.
The kill box still killed my truck in between the cars for no reason. I wasn't out of control and it killed my motor.
So getting the fuel pump back together, do you think it's going to help you?
Yeah, it's the only problem we have with Dink. We're fixing to have it fixed in just a second.
How long should this take?
We'll be out for the next round. All we got to do is put it back on.
All right, Chris Chapman right in the middle of everything going on in the Equalizer pit. And I'll tell you, Greg Holbrook is still continuing to complain about what he thinks was TNT killing his engine in that qualifying run.
Got out his thought of something. Last week in Connecticut, this week in Louisville, everybody, the two top trucks, who are they blaming? TNT. They're not taking any to blame themselves, but Bigfoot's got something to be proud of there. He goes to the next round. He's done what he has to do for the points. Now, what can the Equalizer team do?
You know, you're talking about the complaining about TNT. I think that's just an extension of, boy, huge pressure on these guys to win this title. And Bigfoot right now is able to react positively to that pressure. He can't afford a mistake, and he gets a crucial win right here against Wildhair. Every win inches him closer to a world championship. Let's go to Mike Goss with Andy Brass.
Andy, every race you're closer to the world title.
That's right. You know, it seems like the claim Ford's been running real good for us this evening. You know, the track was laying down pretty good. I think we picked the right gear, and, you know, if we can just stay with the combination we got right now, I think we'll have a good night.
Can you go faster?
I think we can. We're not really pushing that hard right yet. I'm trying to save the truck till we get down into the finals.
This is a big night for you. Any butterflies coming in?
Yeah, it is. You know, I'm getting a little nervous. If we can make it into the finals, that's only three more races, and each race just gets a little bit more and a little bit more.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Andy Brass with a big smile. He hopes it keeps getting bigger. Marvin Smith, by the way, is trying to get the Wildhair into the top 10 in points. Let's go to Chris Chapman.
And Gary Cook,
right in the center of your screen, the team owner. He's holding the light underneath the truck. Could have some big problems that may spell the final death knell for the Equalizer in the battle for the World Championship. Army, we're hearing he's dropped the bell.
Well, if he did, he's going on a trailer, if that's the case. What's going on back inside, though, Scott? That's where the big story is now.
Indeed, and they're going to continue to work on that. We'll continue to find out if that's the case, or if Equalizer will be able to make it back out. Right now, though, Bigfoot needs a win over Outlaw. Critical race, and Andy Brass gets it done again. Boy, he knows he cannot afford a mistake. And, Army, that's a lot of pressure. You've got the best truck. You know you can't mess it up.
Yeah, but one thing I was looking at, the Outlaw was really trying to play the role of the spoiler there. He ran him awfully hard. Had he beaten him on that run, we could have had a different world champion. Look at the start. Andy Brass, I think, almost made a driver error. Came out too hard on the start, but legs it and flies it to the finish line.
It's a simple equation. If Brass wins every one of his races tonight, he's the world champion. Here's Mike Goss again with Andy.
Andy, what can I say? You had some handling problems outdoors this summer. Different story inside.
Yes, it is. And like I said, we did have a lot of problems with the truck as soon as we went outdoors. But it was a handling problem. We finally got it figured out, you know, at the last of the series. And now we're back indoors. You know, the tracks are shorter. The trucks handle a little better. You know, it's getting down to the points are real close. I think if the truck would have handled better earlier outdoors, our points would have been a lot better and it wouldn't have had to come this close, but it has.
The word is Equalizer dropped a valve. He's running on 7 cylinders. Will that affect your driving style the rest of the night?
No, I'm not paying attention to how any of the trucks are running. I'm just kind of watching, trying to stay in my own rut and just been driving like I have all night. Thank you.
We're going to go out now to Chris Chapman. She's in the pits with Mike Wine, who gave it a valiant effort despite losing in the Outlaw. Scott Stevens has made it into the final four, but Army, the big story is the Equalizer. And at the starting line, Equalizer was getting ready to race the Buffalo Tremor, and something died. It can't get it fired back up.
Scott, to where we're getting, he did drop a valve. They're trying to just nurse it through. Points are so important, but he is on the proverbial clock all year long. We've heard about the clock. You've got so much time to get to the line, so much time to run. Well, every 60 seconds takes a minute away from his world championship hopes right now. You can cut the drama in this building. Look at this. Richie Schaefer, they're watching. They're going to give him every opportunity. We're down to 2 minutes now. Scott, I don't believe he's going to make it. I believe that Bigfoot is going to win the world championship with the equalizer setting dead in the water.
He's not getting anywhere. They don't seem to be making any progress at all. Gary Cook, there's the owner of the equalizer. The crowd trying to pick him up, trying to cheer him on.
This has got to be disheartening. And some of the other guys around the truck are other monster truck drivers. Everybody's trying to help this kid. They're not against Bigfoot. They just want to see the world championship won on the racetrack.
Boy, Gary Cook is just feverishly working, but he's down inside the final minute, and the clock is ticking away on any chance of defending the world championship for the equalizer. He had hoped to get it down to one race head-to-head with Bigfoot. It doesn't look like he's going to make it there.
Scott, in this sport, there's been three world champions after tonight. USA One won it the first year. This truck won it the second year. He could have been the only truck to be two times a world champion. He's not going to do it. A blue truck will be the world champion, but what will be the name of that blue truck?
And that's almost like a surrender. You see it there from Gary Cook. He throws his hands up in the air, stick a fork in the equalizer. He is done for this night, and it's going to be Bigfoot winning the world championship. Kind of by default, although take nothing away from Andy Brass. He's going all out. But Andy knows he's got it wrapped up now because equalizer is done for the night. Army, though, as he's towed off, what more can you say about the job this team has done this year? Going through all the disarray earlier in the year when David Morris quit the team in disgust. Gary Cook took a gamble. He went out. He plucked a kid out who had never driven a monster truck before, and they came within a hair of successfully defending the world title.
You know, this is almost like the day after Christmas. We've been chasing
is the world championship. Here's the situation. Due to the breakage of equalizer, we knew Bigfoot had the points lead coming in, so Bigfoot is going to be the 1990 TNT world champion. But Andy Brass, the Bigfoot stable, don't want to back in. They want to go out winners, and they're coming back to lead the semifinals. No problem. Clydesdale, King Crunch, they're there too, and we're coming right back with all the action here on Tough Tracks.
We'll be back. We don't quit.
Yeah, you know, that's the mark of a true champ right
there.
You
know, yeah, I agree with you 100%. They didn't win a championship, but they are winners.
Now, no problem, going to try and spoil Bigfoot's party, but he can't do it.
Oh, the Bigfoot Air Force is flying high in Louisville. Andy Brass is pumped and going to the finals.
Andy Brass, knowing that he is the world champion, Army, that has to take a lot of pressure off of him, yet Andy also doesn't want it to end now. He wants to be the last truck running on this evening.
Yeah, he wants, when there's only one standing, he wants it to be the big acclaimed Bigfoot truck.
He's into the Monster Smash final, and now he's out of the truck. Andy Brass acknowledges the cheers as the world champion. Let's go to Mike Goss with your new champ in Monster Truck Racing.
Andy, congratulations, you just won the world title.
Thank you. Hang on, it feels great. You know, I just like to say that the Acclaim Four was running real good tonight. You know, a little bad luck there with Grade, but thanks to guys like Ford, Acclaim, all of our other sponsors, BDS, KDC Highlights, you know, guys like that, all the guys back at the shop that worked so hard this last week to put the truck back together because we just rolled it, and mainly to my crewman, Donnie, that just he stood with me all year because, like I said, we was having troubles mid-year and helping me put the truck back together. It's kind of tough, but we pulled through it, and it looks like we did it this year.
You feel vindicated at all? I mean, the truck was banned by TNT to let other guys catch up. You didn't feel like that was fair. This has got to make you feel a little better about it.
Yeah, it does. You know, like I say, being kicked out for the 2.5-3 months, you know, really made me feel bad. But it did push some of the other guys to build some other trucks, like Carolina Crusher built him a new truck. And all the guys that did build it have no regrets about building a new truck. But then again, you know, us being banned and being able to come back mid-year and catch up with all the guys at the points, even though we're behind 4 or 5 shows behind Greg and them, we still caught them in the points and passed them. You know, it just feels great.
Again, congratulations.
Well, thank you.
The world champ, boy, he's got a big smile, and he's really going to enjoy this night in Louisville, and I know the offseason getting ready to defend the title in 1991. Well,
what?
There's still business to be done.
You King Crunch.
It is again time to settle matters at Louisville's Freedom Hall. We know who the world champion is. The only thing we don't know is who is the champion on this night. in Louisville, Kentucky. It'll be either Bigfoot and Andy Brass, already crowned as the season champ, or the Auto Value King Crunch, his arch rival and main nemesis in 1990.
Well, we knew it was going to be a blue truck in a winner's circle. Brass is trying to make 100% kill night. Whoa, he does.
Hold on, Scott Stevens. He almost got in big trouble on a wild finish, but Stevens shuts it down before smacking the wall, and Bigfoot goes out in style, winning on the final race of the year. And there, you can see, he really opened up the points on this final night. But that's a deceiving cushion. It was much closer than that all year long. Carolina Crusher, a solid third. King Crunch and King Kong round out the top five in the season standings. 88 champion USA One finishes sixth. Outlaw, very impressive, seventh place run. Then eighth, the Nightlife. Gravedigger holds on for the number nine spot. And Buffalo Tremor, Johnny K, rounds out the top 10. Clydesdale will finish 11th. Marvin Smith's Wild Hair holds off no problem for 12th. Then Thunder Chicken and Mad Dog round out the top 15 for the 1990 season in TNT Monster Truck Racing.
Yeah, but Scott, right now it's official. Bigfoot is king of the monster truck.
So the world champion has been crowned, and he does it going out in style. Andy Brass and Bigfoot, the champion of the world in TNT Monster Truck Racing. Congratulations.
Thank you, Scott. I appreciate it. I want to just thank everybody. Like I say, thank Acclaim, Ford, all the guys back there, all the guys back in the shop. We run the speedway here a couple months ago. We took one out of the wins there, took the second place. Take two first here, just great, you know.
As King Crunch leaves the building right now, Andy, basically I got one more question for you. Was it any sweeter because the last one came against Scott Stevens and King Crunch, who you've had such a battle and a rivalry with all year?
Yeah, it was. You know, I kind of wanted to hurry up and get on the line. I figured I'm going to put some pressure on him, make him hurry up and squeeze him on the time there, you know. And Scott and I have had a rivalry all year. You know, he's really against the truck and stuff, but we come back here to prove him. We was out for 3.5 months with the truck. We come back, took the point series with it, and it just goes to show that, you know, the truck was working good, did us a good job, and we was able to come back and do it even though we was out.
Celebration time.
That's right.
Andy Brass, the champion driver, and here's the man who started it all, Bob Chandler. The champion now with the Bigfoot truck of the TNT Monster Truck Challenge. And, you know, we do have to just say a big congratulations. And I guess this is really a test of perseverance. You got so close the first year, you went with a different attack. You went through some rules you didn't like. You sat out of band. Now you're the champion.
Yeah, I really appreciate that. I don't think this truck would be here without Andy Brass. I mean, he's a heck of a driver, he's a heck of a racer. But I really want to thank everybody that supported us over the years. And I'm happy as hell.
They close it out as number one. But that sure doesn't close us out on Tough Tracks. More great action coming up next week. For Army Armstrong and Chris Chapman, I'm Scott Douglas. Bigfoot's the champ here on Tough Tracks.